Towards the net, blocked down in front, rebound scores! Evan Oakley, here's Farmer on a breakaway, Farmer scores! Short-handed break, Benzine in on Zevnik. Oh, what a great left pad save there. Shot deflected, they score! Cullen stops short-handed!
You're listening to Wildcats Hockey, presented by Armored Roofing on the Wildcats Broadcast Network.
A very good evening to you from the King Yeager Coliseum, where it is time for Wildcats Hockey, presented by Armored Roofing. Hello and welcome to the broadcast. Ben Orner with you, Wildcats fans. Thanks so much for making us a part of your Friday evening plans as we kick off the weekend, as the Wildcats look to wrap up their weekend with 2 points against the IceRays and finish off this 8-game homestand with a win. The Wildcats come into tonight's contest 5-2 on this current 8-game homestand. They've certainly done much better than they did last year on the corresponding set of fixtures. They struggled to pick up wins at home in January last year. Has not been the case thus far, but tonight will feature an IceRays team hungry to get back in the win column after last night. They were playing catch-up all night long. At the end of the day, they were not able to overhaul an early 2-0 lead for the Wildcats. We'll break that all down in just a second, but let's set the scene before we go any further. The Wildcats come into tonight's contest with a record of 27-10-0. Just one of two teams in the North American Hockey League who have yet to be dealt an overtime or shootout loss. Wildcats are 18-4-0 as the home team. They are 16-4-0 in the K. Yeager Coliseum, 24-9-0 in the division, and they sit third place in the South Division standings, just 1 point back of the Idle Lone Star Brahmas and 5 points back of the Topeka Roadrunners, who are playing host to Rio Grande Valley here this evening. Corpus Christi on the other end of the ice comes into tonight's action 19-13-5 after last night's loss. They're 1-11-5 away from the American Bank Center and are 18-12-4 in South Division play. They currently sit in fourth place, 11 points back of the Wildcats. And although the Wildcats are certainly concerned with overhauling Lone Star and Topeka ahead of them, they are still a bit concerned, or have to be a bit cognizant, of the ice rain sneaking up upon them last night. And were a sweep to have transpired in favor of the Rays this weekend, a 9-point lead would have been cut to 5 for the Wildcats over the fourth place ice Rays. But last night's win ensures that the deficit can be no less than 9 points for the Ice Rays when they head back to Corpus Christi. But the Wildcats, who are 11 points ahead of Corpus Christi entering tonight's game, will be hoping to send them back with a 13-point deficit. If they can round out the weekend sweep here this evening, they just might be able to do that. The Wildcats last night used a couple of power play goals, and in fact, both teams used the power play to their advantage in the first two periods, as the Wildcats opened up a 2-0 lead last night through the first 3 minutes and 45 seconds of the first period. After Austin Bolio had shanked an empty net chance just 30 seconds into the game, it seemed like maybe his snake bit spell would continue, but he broke a 5-game scoreless spell with a power play tally, his 15th goal of the season. And then after Corpus Christi took a power play on that same goal-scoring sequence, the Wildcats went right back to work on another power play. This time it was Townsend putting it upstairs after a nice centering feed from Colin Staub. Incidentally, that point for Colin on the assist was his 100th as a member of the Wildcats. More on that in a moment. But after that, the Wildcats traded power play goals, and they were leading 3-2 heading into the third period. Jake Townsend and Paul Subri would score in the third, but Tanner Lomzis and Maxime Giosvili would score for Corpus Christi. Every time the Wildcats opened up a two-goal edge, the Ice Rays would roar right back and pull within one, and it seemed like the Wildcats were in for a very nervy ending of the contest, and they were a little bit, but the defense and Austin Shaw played well in their own zone in the waning minutes of last night's contest. The 5-on-5 play was very solid from the Wildcats from their goal line on out. They'll be looking for more of the same here this evening, and they'll be looking to stay out of the box. The penalty kill has been an area where the Wildcats need to improve, and I had a chance to talk with Wildcats head coach John LaFontaine before the game, as I do every game, and he said to me, you can expect to see changes in the penalty kill setup. It seems like the Wildcats are going to start to simplify things here and make it a little bit easier for those penalty killers to get the puck on their stick and get it down the ice rather than too much extra movement, which, when you're on the penalty kill, can quickly turn into wasted movement. And It's the difference of a split second on the PK between getting a stick in the shooting lane and having one zip over your goaltender's shoulder for a goal top shelf. The Wildcats looking to simplify on the PK tonight. They are 15 for 21 on the penalty kill against Corpus Christi this year, just 71.4% against the IceRays, and they've been dropping precipitously through the league rankings on the PK, have the Wildcats. Over the last few weeks, they've fallen down to 16th on the PK, 81.4%, as I mentioned, good for 16th. In the North American Hockey League, but the Wildcats will be hoping to keep it to 5-on-5. Obviously, they won't mind going on the power play themselves after going 3-for-6 on the man advantage last night, but they'll look to keep this one 5-on-5 as they did control 5-on-5 play last night. Another positive out of last night, aside from the strong power play performances, Wildcats got big contributions from Austin Beaulieu. And Beaulieu is a guy who had been struggling a little bit heading into last night's game. He had a 7-game goalless spell and a 5-game pointless spell heading into Thursday's contest. He got a goal and 2 assists in that game for a 3-point game, just one of a handful of 3-point games he's posted on the air. But for Beaulieu and for the Wildcats, that's good news. Wichita Falls is 21-2-0 when Austin B records at least 1 point. And of course, I do have to add that it last initial to clarify, the Wildcats now boasting 5 Austins on the roster. A little bit of an anomaly there and a fun one for yours truly to try and sort out. But Beaulieu, good to see him bust out in a big way last night. And if you remember back to the beginning of the season, it took him a little bit to get going through about the first 4 or 5 games of the season. But once he did get going, he was nearly impossible to stop for the next 3 to 4 weeks. And the Wildcats would love to see more of that here this evening. And for Beaulieu, it was not a matter of not being in the right spots. It was not a matter of working hard. It was not a matter of not playing well. It was a matter of being a little bit snake bit and not having the puck fall where he needed it to. Last night, he got a little bit of the little bit more friendly bounces, and he was able to capitalize on them. His vision has been good. His positioning has been good. And a unit that has featured he, APAP, and Eric Yeager has looked very strong throughout the last few weeks. Although, it should be mentioned that that Beaulieu and APAP did shift with Colin Saab after Eric Yeager got shifted back to defense for the third period. I mentioned the forwards there. No changes throughout the forward lines from last night for the Wildcats, but one change on defense as Konstantin Chernyuk is out tonight. Shane Kuzmeski, who was out last night, will slide in directly in his place. Kuzmeski playing in game number 35 on the year, and if he's hungry, it means good things for the Wildcats because he has played well against his Corpus Christi squad this year. Picked up his first career goal back on October the 31st against the IceRays, and had a 5-point weekend against Corpus Christi back in December here in this building, including a 4-point game on a goal and 3 assists in that big 8-2 win on that Saturday night. So if Kuzmeski can jump in from the blue line, it could be a good boost to a Wildcat squad that also broke a spell of over 200 minutes without an even strength goal last night. Jake Townsend's goal at a minute 26 of the third period broke a lengthy spell, and the Wildcats were certainly happy to get that one done and dusted behind them, as they wound up picking up the game-winning goal on an even-strength tally as well. Paul Soubry, 6th of the year, stood as the game winner in that one. One other change for the lineup for the Wildcats to alert you to. It'll be David Zebnik getting the call in the blue paint tonight. Austin Shaw had started 5 in a row as Zebnik had recovered from a bit of a lower body tweak, not quite an injury, but a tweak. Zebnik is good to go tonight, and go he will. Of course, that's a perfect segue into the starting lineups brought to you by Pelicans Restaurant. We start with the visiting Corpus Christi IceRays. On the blue line, we'll start on the defense on the left side. It'll be number 4, Anthony Cortez, 5'10", 180 pounds, out of Pierrefonds, Quebec, most recently of the Charlottetown Islanders of the Quebec Major Junior League. Cortez has 34 points on the year on 10 goals and 24 assists. Pairing with him will be Logan Gestro. Gestro on the right side has 32 games played under his belt. He's got 3 goals and 10 assists. Hailing out of South Lyon, Michigan, Gestro stands at 6'3", 205 pounds. For the forwards for Corpus Christi on the left wing will be Maxim Giosvili. Giosvili out of Moscow, Russia, a 96 birth year, is 6'5", 220 pounds. Had a goal last night. He's got 2 goals to his credit and 3 points in 5 games played since coming down to the IceRays from the Bloomington Thunder. On the right, or centering the starting line, will be Matt Colford, number 8, recently acquired from the Minnesota Magicians out of Champlin, Minnesota. He's a 94 birth year, 5'10", 185 is Colford, playing in game number 38 on the year is Colford. And game number 6 with the Ice Rays on the season, Colford has 21 points on 8 goals and 13 assists. On the right wing, it'll be Joseph Chitwood playing in game number 28 for number 61. 2 goals and 8 assists for the Carmel, Indiana native, who stands at 5'9", 190 pounds, had an assist in last night's contest. And getting the start in net tonight, we see Luke Picar. 13 games played for number 1, 5'5", with a 280 goals against average and a 901 save percentage. Picar, a 96th birth year, stands at 6'2", 190 pounds, and hails from Linwood, Washington. Head coach of the Ice Rays is John Mechanic. Assistant coach is Brad Flynn. Now for the starting lineup for your Wichita Falls Wildcats. Again, we'll start on the forwards. On the left wing, it'll be Max Reisinger out of Alding, Austria. Reisinger has seven points in 5 games against the Ice Rays this year. 13 goals, 9 assists for 22 points total on the year for the 6'195 Max out of Walding, Austria. Centering will be the Air Force Academy commit, Colin Staub, 6'1", 195 pounds, out of Colorado Springs, Colorado. Staub on the year leads the team in points with 38. He's got 14 goals and 24 assists in 37 games played. On the right wing will be Johnny Lazarus, 6'1", 180 pounds, out of Syosset, New York. 19 points on the year for the first-year man from Long Island, 8 goals and 11 assists for Lazarus, wearing number 22. On the blue line, it'll be number 20, Austin Azzanaro out of Spokane Valley, Washington, getting the start in just his second game in the North American Hockey League, 6 foot, 185 pounds. He made his debut last night and gave a good account of himself. More on him as we go along. Pairing with Azzanaro will be Jake Townsend, 6 foot, 180 pounds, out of Highlands Ranch, Colorado. Picked up a pair of tallies last night. That gives him 8 on the year, tying a career high. He's got 23 points in 37 games played. And starting in net is David Zevnik, 5'11", 160 pounds, out of Lakeville, Minnesota, the 94 birth year. Wears number 30. He comes in 11-5-0 with a 2.62 goals against average and a 9.06 save percentage. Head coach of the Wildcats is John LaFontaine. Chris Saransky is the assistant in his second season. Tonight's officials, Eric Krasichuk is the referee, Michael Anderson and Aaron Schacht are the linesmen. Those are the starting lineups brought to you by Pelicans Restaurant, located at 2301 Midwestern Parkway, across from Midwestern State University. Pelicans Restaurant offers Texoma the choicest beef, freshest fish, and the area's best wine list. Next time you're in the Falls, be sure to stop by and see our friends at Pelicans Restaurant for fine dining in a family atmosphere. That'll do it on the pregame show. We'll step aside. When we come back, we'll have the opening faceoff between the Wildcats and the Ice Rays right here from the KYC. Wildcats hockey presented by Armored Roofing gets underway just after this on FastHockey.com and the Wildcats Broadcast Network. Good evening to you from the K. Yeager Coliseum, where the ice is down, the lights are up, and we are just about set for Wildcats Hockey, presented by Armored Roofing. Hello, welcome to the broadcast, everybody. Ben Horner with you on FastHockey.com and the Wildcats Broadcast Network. Thanks for making us a part of your Friday evening plans as the Wildcats look to close out their eight-game homestand with a high note and a win against the Corpus Christi IceRays. They're 3-0-0 against the Rays in this building, looking to make it 4-0-0 here tonight. David Zemnick in the cage to our right as the Cats skate PDQ across our keyboard wearing their home white sweaters. Luke Picar in the cage to our left as we see the backup goalies from last night get the calls for the start here this evening. Ice Rains wearing their road black sweaters with red accents and white lettering moving from left to right across your screen. Brazichuk is the referee. He'll bring Staub and Colford together. As we are set for the action here, and the puck is down, we're underway in the first period, brought to you by American Classified, as right away the Ice Rays will have to chase this one back into their own zone. In on a quick forecheck here is Max Reisinger, hammered all the way down the ice. This won't go for icing here, as beating the race was Colford. Colford digs for it. Chitwood couldn't grab the rebound, as this is Reisinger flubbing a pass up the ice. Colford has it in front of the Wildcats bench area, ridden into the wall there by Reisinger, but he worked it back to Cortez. Now here's a big slap shot into the glove and held there by Zebnik. Had to struggle to hold control of that one, but he made the save, and we'll get the whistle just 28 seconds into the first period on a big blast from Logan Gestro. Zebnik making his first appearance since January the 6th when he posted 22 saves in a 5-2 win over Amarillo. He's, as I mentioned, 11-5-0 on the year with a .262 goals against and a .906 save percentage. Faceoff will come to his right as Farmer is out there to take the draw. Controlled here by the Wildcats below the goal line, this is Cook. Cook bumps it back along there for Cam Knight, as Knight slows things down, doesn't like his options in front, and swivels back before playing it along for Cook. Cook floats this one up ahead for Jaeger. Jaeger will take it off the wall and float this in deep. First of this one here where the Ice Rays trying to hold the zone on the near side. They're not able to do so are the Cats. As looking to motor forward, here's Lobsis. His shot wide of the cage. First to it here is Corpus Christi trying to go down the wall towards the corner, but is intercepted by Bolio. Bolio now has APAP in front as Bolio walks in and gains his own. Bolio ragging this one, protecting at the wall, needing to play a pass, and does. Finds Baum fresh from the bench. Baum couldn't handle it cleanly, so he plays down low. First to it here where the Ice Rays. This one cleared all the way down the ice. Will it go for icing? Yes, it will, with 18:42 remaining in the first period. Zebnik, you heard his overall numbers at home. He's been very strong, 9-2-0 at the KYC. .209 goals against average and a .922 save percentage. He is 1-0 against the Ice Rays this year. Picked up a win in that 7-1 triumph for the Cats back here on December the 5th. Offensive zone faceoff for the Wildcats. A minute and 18 seconds into this contest. Scoreless here from the KYC. Michaud resets himself as he'll take the draw against Farmer. Clean win back to the point. Townsend, one-timer, goes up high, gets the glass, caroming around there and chopping at it were a couple of guys, but it's ramped up the glass and out by the Ice Rays. Settled here by Azenaro. Worked quickly along for Townsend. Townsend can't get to the red line, but he was able to get just over to negate the icing here as going in towards the corner and trying to hold his own are the Cats. Azenaro towards the net looking for a deflection there. Went under the stick of Sherazin. Farmer on the far side half while just outside the circle will try to protect here as Falconer gets involved. Farmer hacking at it there. The Wildcats hold the zone nicely as it's Townsend walking to the middle. Azenaro now towards the net, deflected, and it goes wide to the short side. Farmer looking to stash back out in front. Instead goes up to the blue line. Azenaro holding, shot off a leg there and rocketed away into the corner coming from the stick of Howe. Wildcats will start up a change on the fly as picking this one up is Kruger getting to the red line, floating this one high and wide of the cage. Townsend the first to it there for Wichita Falls, rolls it up the boards where it's taken by Oakley. Oakley chips in. Litviak going in after it there, not able to reach this one first, but Baum pressed into the wall here will keep play moving for the time being. Wildcats jamming for this one at the blue line. That's Litviak stashing it below the goal line as first to it here where the Ice Rays. In their own defensive zone, they try to clear. Litviak was able to hold pressure as this is held in at the blue line as Baum will float this towards the corner. First to it here is Spillum, knocking around through the neutral zone. Litviak has it on his stick once more, needs to play a pass, gives it back to Baum, and Baum will turn it up ice and give along to Kuzmeski. Pass cross ice, too hot for Oakley to handle. Litviak gains the zone onside. His pass, looking for a man at the blue line. Never got all the way through. Oakley looks to settle as it trickled towards the slot, and he wasn't able to do so. This sent all the way down the ice. Will it go for icing? Yes, it will, as Cam Knight was fresh from the bench and first back to it. 16:58 remaining in the first. Scoreless here from the KYC as the Wildcats trying to get an early start to this one with a 5-on-5 goal. Luke Pickard gets you his numbers. 5-5-2, 2.80 goals against average and a 9.01 save percentage. On the road, 0-5-2 with a 3.23 goals against and an 8.87 save percentage. Against the Wildcats this year, one game played, did not play a whole game, did not get a win or a loss, 4.86 goals against average and an 8.52 save percentage after he had relieved Lindgren in that first game of that weekend set back in December. Puck is loose in the skates of Lazarus. He'll kick it along there, and it goes to the corner. First to it there was Liliev. The Wildcats are able to hold the zone, but only momentarily, as this is floated down the ice. No icing here. It's waved off by the linesman on the near side. That's Shaq, as Cook will step away and play it along for Staub. Staub under some pressure here. He'll skate through the check. Lost out on the puck. This one in and out of the glove of Cam Knight. First to it here is Chitwood. Getting involved is Gioschvili. Gioschvili jabs towards the corner. He'll go and pursue Cook, who's under pressure. Gioschvili took it away there. Skittered towards the front of the net, but stopped that, stashed it only as far as the blue line. Back below his own net, here is Cam Knight spinning away from the forechecking Chitwood and giving it along for Matt Cook. Cook, a dangerous pass there, evades everybody, including Gioschvili, the third man high, and goes back into the defensive zone of the Ice Rays. Gioschvili softly on his backhand plays this one behind the cage of David Zebnik. First to it here is Matt Cook. He tried to bump it back along, never got all the way through as it works its way to the near side corner. Gioschvili down below the goal line trying to stash out in front. Loose there at the side of the cage, and Cam Knight will pick this one up and look to motor forward. Got it up ahead to Risinger. Risinger at the red line. Now it's Apap looking for Beaulieu there, and a good defensive stick broke that play up. Back the other way, here's Ryan Kuzin. Kuzin cuts towards the middle looking for a trailer here. He finds him. This is Westmead Shod walking down the right wing wall as it spiked away from him there by an alert Azenaro. Beaulieu now up the ice. His pass was too far for Jaeger. Getting in on the forecheck, here's Azenaro, swept it towards the net off a friendly carom, and it went wide of the cage. He'll retreat back to the blue line and retake his place on defense, as on the far side, it's taken by Lomsnes. Gestro, put under some pressure there by the forechecking Eric Jaeger. Headman pass, that's off a stick of Lomsnes. It will come up short of icing as it skipped at the last second, as having some pressure here is Azenaro. Nice move to find some space and work it along as Beaulieu moves this one ahead for Jaeger. Jaeger gains a zone at the right wing side. Left behind here for Farmer. Shot towards the net. Punched away there, and Townsend wasn't able to step onto the rebound as Pickard will cover up. 5:02 played in the first period. 0-0 is the score here from the KYC. Ben Horner with you on FastHockey.com and the Wildcats Broadcast Network. And, of course, let me remind you, this period of play brought to you by American Classified. No score yet, as the Wildcats and Ice Rays skating up and down the ice at a pretty good clip thus far. Watch out of the draw here is Kruger. Face off to the right of Pickard will be taken by Jessica and Farmer. Farmer knocked this draw to the near side half wall, trying to hold the zone, but not able to do so, was Falconer. Kosmeski swept this one back into the neutral zone here, coming along to get involved. This is Sherazin and Farmer trying to dig it free. Kosmeski pulled it from the wall but gave it away there to Jessica on the forecheck. Jessica into the corner there. Kosmeski picks his pocket and looks to spin away. Here is Shane Kosmeski walking up the left wing wall, played towards the middle there dangerously, but the Wildcats are able to escape the zone as Kosmeski plays this one up ahead for Sherazin. Sherazin had it swatted away from him there by Crenon. Held in here barely by the Wildcats. Generous call by the linesman near side. That was Anderson. It was Baum who had held the zone, at least nominally. It's been sent back into the neutral zone, and the Wildcats, wanting to change, will put it in deep. 10 remaining in a scoreless first period. In the neutral zone here, this is Cam Knight having some trouble with it here. Back to support was Evan Oakley. Shifted it quickly along for Matt Cook. Cook, as we hit 14 minutes remaining in a scoreless first, worked it along for Knight. Knight through the middle of the ice nicely here, and will play this one in deep and go into the corner. Subri wasn't able to beat this one here. Oakley can't hold his own. Cam Knight has it skitter off his skate. He'll have to retreat back to the neutral zone and grab this one as he'll work it quickly up ahead for Litviak. Here is Litviak now looking to play across along the blue line. He finds Knight. Shot saved. Rebound is loose. Shot saved once more coming from the stick of Subri. Now look out. Racing the other way. Here's Liliev on a clean break. Liliev in all alone. And a bad save by Zebnik. And a penalty upcoming here. It'll be a slashing call, and Matt Cook will head over to the box, but Zemnik comes up with a big left pad save there to keep this one scoreless. Lily have raced in. As we see, Matt Cook took the slash at the last second, and that was just enough to disrupt play. So the Wildcats will see the new simplified penalty kill, Gilmore's Collision Center PK, coming up here for Wichita Falls. They were only 2-for-4 on the PK last night. We'll see if they can perform a little bit better. Off to the left of Zemnik here. On the year, the Cats are 81.4% on the penalty kill. Generally speaking, anything above 85% is considered better than good. Washed out of the draw here is Michaud, so Kuzin will take it, going against Apap. Apap won this draw. It's picked up here by Staub. He'll try to dig this one free, but he wasn't able to do so. Lomzis gloves this one down, skittering around here. It's picked up by Kuzmeski. Tries to chip past Michaud and wasn't able to do so. Off to the far side. Shot backdoor there, looking for Lomzis, and it was behind him as Michaud re-corrals to the middle of the point. This is Cortez. Now into the corner, fed towards the middle there. Still a little jam for it below the goal line. Gios Feely wasn't able to find a teammate as slinging this one all the way down the ice was Jake Townsend. 5 seconds gone on the penalty to Matt Cook here. One of the Wildcats' top PK men sitting in the box. Apap lost a stick and a glove. He'll come to the bench for a change as gaining the zone. Here is Lomzis. Drops it back here for Kuzin. Kuzin holds on it. Quick shot. Save there. Might have not gotten blocked in front as it's bumped off the back wall and picked here by Lomzis. To the blue line and Michaud. Michaud along for Kuzin now at the left point. Kuzin, top of the left circle. Michaud now into the middle of the zone. Michaud walking towards the left. Now we'll give it back towards the middle. Here's a slap shot. They score. It's Anthony Cortez on the power play. The penalty kill, not able to do the job again. And the Wildcats trail for the first time this weekend. Wait to see a replay. I thought Zemnik might have been able to get a little bit farther out to cut down the angle. Might have been screened, but either way, the Wildcats trail. That is the first time in the last 5 or 6 road games that Corpus has scored the first goal. 12:23 remaining in the first as the Wildcats gave up a breakaway, had to take a penalty, and then couldn't kill off the remaining time. There was 57 seconds remaining in the penalty to Matt Cook when Cortez let one rip from inside the blue line. And that's where the Wildcats stand. Corpus Christi, by the way, 14-1-1 when scoring first. As off the faceoff, this is Shane Kuzmeski working it forward as Oakley lobs this one in deep. First to it here is Litviak, ridden off there in the corner. Oakley tries to pull this one free from Kanaan. Up to the blue line and Kuzmeski worked it along for Baum, who doesn't hold the zone. Thought he might have just barely, as the Wildcats will tag up. No, they will not. It landed on the stick of Litviak. We'll get the whistle to stop play. 12:02 remaining in the first period. The Wildcats now trailing 1-0. Zemnik, who made a big toe save on that breakaway attempt for Liliev, was probably screened, would be my guess, on that goal as it found its way into the top corner. Faceoff controlled here by the Ice Rays. This is Huser, who will play this one back. He was hoping for Kanaan. Kanaan has to chase back into his own corner as we have over 8 minutes played in the first from the KYC. Ben Horner with you on FastHockey.com and the Wildcats Broadcast Network. Headman pass is going to be tipped along, so there's no icing. Zemnik will roll this one around the glass. Didn't reach Reisinger, his intended target, as this is Kuzmeski fighting through the slash and sweeping it along. Lazarus couldn't reach towards the net. Skittering around there, fought off by Zemnik nicely. Played towards the near side. Oh, and a toe save by Zemnik. Huser towards the net, and it's dashed off the outside of the cage as the Wildcats are scrambling in their own zone right now. Flung forward there by Lazarus. Blind pass intercepted. Floated wide of the cage of Zemnik, who is standing on his head through the first 9-plus minutes. Otherwise, this one could be 3-0 Rays already. Through the middle of the ice, Wildcats still struggle to control, trying to knock this one down in the neutral zone. But we'll get a whistle, and it'll be for a hand pass. 11:06 remaining in the first. The Wildcats trailing 1-0 on a power play goal from Anthony Cortez. Cortez, goal number 12 on the year. Point number 35. As the hand pass, we'll see the faceoff move to the center ice. Bolio going at it there with Howe. Howe was out last night, serving a 1-game suspension. Back in tonight, the defenseman playing on the right wing. Off the faceoff, Bolio will combine to win this one back to Townsend. Townsend gains the zone at the blue line. Now puts on the brakes and will chip down low towards the corner. Apap trying to dig it free there. Kruger beat him to the spot. Jesko looks to sweep this one up the wall, and it's worked forward here by Kruger. Kruger chip past Townsend. Azenaro steps in front of Howe there. Has some trouble with it, but he was able to chip it free. One handing it along there was Jaeger. Wildcats not able to clear the zone. Jaeger will re-corral. Bumps, but not out of the zone. Big slap shot. Goes all the way around the boards. Bolio will take this on the near side. Couldn't dig it out and find a teammate with it. As below the goal line, or rather at the half wall, outside the circle, working towards the goal line, was Kruger. This one squirted free between the blue liners for the Ice Rays and squirts all the way back down. Both teams will start up a line change here as we tick down towards 10 minutes played in the first period as the Wildcats are trailing 1-0. Forecheck is Sherrison. Breaking said forecheck where the Ice Rays. Chitwood plays this one in deep. Got some help there from Gioschvili as Farmer is first back to it here. Farmer, look out, almost a turnover, but he'll be able to skate onto this one and move it up ahead for Sherrison. Sherrison fights through the check, drags at the blue line. Falconer steps onto this one, has his pocket picked from behind as this is sent down the ice by the Ice Rays. This will trickle towards the cage of Zevnik. He'll play this one onto the blade of Cam Knight. Knight spins away from Chitwood once and then twice, and now comes up the ice. Here is Cam Knight looking to play a pass as he'll chip it softly towards some space. No icing here as Falconer goes in on the forecheck there. He'll battle nicely with Taylor Carl trying to work it free. Here is Sherrison. Sherrison puts on the brakes in the corner. Needing some support is Sherrison as coming to the bench is Falconer. Oakley fresh out there as the Wildcats are trying to change on the fly. Farmer and Sherrison still having the puck tied up along the far side. Farmer will extricate himself and Oakley will go in as Farmer will now come to the bench for a change. Here is Sherrison. He wasn't able to hold the puck on the second attempt as now it's Cam Knight in his own zone looking to curl all the way up the ice as Sherrison gets off the bench or onto the bench and Litviak gets on the ice from the bench. Here is the aforementioned Litviak walking down the middle. Shot fought up there. Big juicy rebound. And it's held in there by Oakley on the far side. Oakley touched towards the middle. Litviak walks down low. Litviak in front. And he was hooked away at the last second. Couldn't pull the trigger. Some nifty moves there by the Russian. But he wasn't able to get a scoring chance out of it. Here's Azenaro. Did he hold the zone? Yes, he did. No hand pass either. Now on a second attempt, the Wildcats have to retreat back into their own zone. Spun quickly along to Townsend by Azenaro. Now Litviak gains his zone onside. He'll take it to the right wing wall. His pass fed along hoping for Azenaro. Kuzin disrupted play. Azenaro sends it below the goal line where it's played by Cronon. Cronon chipped it along past Oakley, or rather past Litviak, and then moved it along as the Wildcats will start forward once more. Litviak didn't like the route in front of him, so he'll move it forward. Gives to Townsend, gets it back. Here's Litviak now, taking it to the right wing wall. Drops for Townsend. Swung along, here's Baum. His shot goes high and gets the glass. Lomsnes looks to pick up this one on the far side half wall and does with 8 minutes remaining in the first period as the Wildcats are starting to warm to the task a little bit here. Townsend has some trouble with this one. Baum sweeps it up the ice as Farmer will swoop forward. Onside play. Reisinger can't hold the zone. He'll switch it back along for Baum on the far side as the Wildcats look to settle and start up the ice. Staub swept this one in deep. Pickard leaves this one sitting behind the cage where Jesko will come along to grab it. Held in nicely by Baum at the blue line. Into the corner for Staub. Toe drag towards the middle in front. Reisinger had his stick tied up there and he couldn't clean up his own rebound. 7.5 minutes remaining in the first period. Cats trailing 1-0. Ozevnik steps away from his crease to play this one. Staub rolls it back along the high glass. Jesko the first to it here. Slap pass towards the middle. Kicked off the goal line there alertly by Kuzmeski. Now led forward. Here's Jaeger. Partial break. Jaeger in front. Shot and a toe save there by Pickar as Jaeger had a one-on-one shot there. 7 minutes remaining in the first. Best look of the game for the Wildcats right there. No icing as Cam Knight pursues back and shifts it along. Here is Matt Cook. Cook has some traffic in front. He was able to find Apap. Apap can't win the race after this one skittered off his blade, and the Wildcats will have to reset. Great pace to this first period here. Headman pass. Apap, no icing here. Pickard put under some pressure. Rolled around the boards. Bolio the first to it here on the far side. Puts on the brakes. Left it there for Jaeger. Jaeger down low for Apap now. Apap tied up below the goal line. Bolio comes along. Hook down in front. Here's Jaeger. Backhander save. Puck still loose. Follow-up chance. Rebound. And it's cleared away. Only as far as Cook. Spins it towards the net. Bolio holds in. Tries to find Cam Knight there as he canceled out with his man. But the Ice Rays are able to start this forward. Chitwood. Quick shot. Blocked there by Austin Bolio as Eric Jaeger comes back in his own zone to play some defense. Eric Jaeger having some trouble with it there. Tied up. Penalty upcoming here against Corpus Christi. Headman pass for Sherrison. No icing here. Well, we will get an icing, but we'll get the whistle on the touch-up on the penalty from Luke Pickard. As the Wildcats have a couple of great chances, 6:06 remaining in the first, and they'll head to the power play for the first time this evening. Skating over to the box is going to be Jessica. Got a little too over-anxious on the forecheck and took a hooking minor as he was trying to take Bolio and then Cam Knight off the puck. Wildcats 3-for-6 on the man advantage last night. They are 9-for-25 on the power play against Corpus this year. Off the faceoff, this is Lazarus. Left it there for Cook, who looks to go all the way around the boards. Comes to the near side corner. Farmer ridden off it there, trying to dig it free. Was Reisinger. Farmer slowly up the wall. Lazarus will hold this one in. Lazarus needing some support here. It squirts free as shorthanded. It's on the stick of Wes Michaud. Michaud will play this one around as it goes all the way down, as Cook will take this one there. Cook rides off the forechecking Wes Michaud and gives it along for Farmer. Farmer up ahead, hoping for Reisinger here. Settled on here by Sherrison. Loading shot blocked there, and that stung a man in front. Sherrison looks to walk towards the middle. Now Sherrison can't jab it towards the front of the net as Reisinger sweeps this up to the blue line for Cook. Here is Cook. Gives it to Reisinger now. Rather, this is Sherrison. His pass intercepted. Loose puck here, and Cortez hammers this one all the way down the ice. Minute 10 remaining in the power play for Wichita Falls. 5:10 remaining in the first period as they trail 1-0. Bolio leaves this one for Cam Knight. Knight lumbers this one forward, puts on the brakes as he gets just inside the blue line. Staub leaves it there for Bolio in the corner. Bolio ridden off it here below the goal line. This is Staub hooked in front there. Apap trying to tuck it free as a man had worked down low. That was Townsend trying to hold the zone where the Wildcats, no penalty upcoming here as the Corpus Christi bench wanted one. Apap trying to dig this one loose in the last 35 of the power play. Townsend stood on the puck here. Knight looks to hold the zone. He did so momentarily. Wildcats are able to hold the zone. Townsend got along for Apap. Bolio's in front. Apap shakes it back to Knight. Quick shot blocked in front there. Or rather, that was Townsend on the quick effort, and that's wired all the way down the ice on the clear. 4:20 remaining in the first. 15 seconds remaining in the Wildcats power play. They're trailing 1-0 here as Cook gives this one along for Litviak at the right wing side. Litviak left it behind here. He'll re-corral in the corner. Litviak, his pass, hoping for Kuzmeski, was right onto the stick of Chitwood here. Chitwood played it forward for a teammate, but it was intercepted. Litviak, pass. It was on to Jessica, fresh from the box. Here's Jessica into the zone, and he's forced wide there by Kuzmeski as Kuzmeski clears but not out. Here is Kelly into the corner, walking out in front there, and it trickles wide of the cage. Cook the first to it here for the Wildcats. Under 4 minutes remaining in this first period, as this is Nikita Litviak taking it from Subri. Oh, Litviak ridden down hard. We're going to get another penalty upcoming here. This is Oakley walking forward. Delayed off a penalty. Shot glove save there from Kuzmeski. We'll see. 2 or 5. Litviak was run down hard from behind. 3:36 remaining. It's a checking from behind call. The Wildcats just came up empty on their power play, and they're going to head back to it here. Would be 2 or 5. Looks like it'll be 2 minutes for checking from behind for Connor Kelly. That is exactly what it will be. Not a 5-minute major, but the Wildcats, who were empty on that power play just a moment ago, will get a second crack at it. Well, hang on a second. It might be a 2 and a 10 because Kruger is skating over to serve a penalty. So my guess is 2 and a 10 for checking from behind. Face off one here by the IceRays, but they can't clear the zone. Reisinger tied up there on the far side as this is Gestro sending it the length. Minutes for checking from behind, and a 10-minute misconduct is the call. Reisinger left this one behind, and it's sent all the way back once more. A minute 35 remaining in the Wildcats' second power play of the evening. 3:10 remaining in the first. They trail 1-0 as Townsend will walk this one slowly forward. He got to the blue line and chipped this one towards the corner. It dies there below the goal line. Farmer tries to dig this one free. Here's Sherrison. Sherrison skates off to the far side wall. Sherrison needs somewhere to go with it there. Has some trouble. Holds his zone. Now on a second attempt, wasn't able to do so. Hooked it back to the neutral zone there to negate the offside as the Wildcats tag up. Here is Townsend. tries to chip it forward for Sherazin to skate onto. Sherazin and Risinger go into the corner to try and dig it free. Four Wildcats bunched up below the goal line now with a minute remaining in their power play. 2:35 remaining in the first. Fed towards the middle there, hoping for Risinger. It was intercepted. Good attempt, good idea there by Staub, but the Ice Rays had it read. Townsend picking it up behind the cage of Zevnik. Zevnik will look to start this forward. Townsend left it there for Matt Cook with 40 seconds remaining in the power play. Cook almost mishandled, but was able to take it to the wall. Lost out here as this is cleared, but it caroms off a leg. Off to the far side it goes, where it'll be wired all the way down the ice by Nathan Breyer. Here is Austin Bolio now. Back to collect. In the last 25 of the power play, the Wildcats have not gotten much going here. Bolio walks through, lost the puck at the last second, and it's floated in deep. It was wide of the cage of Zevnik. He'll leave this one here in the last 15 of the Wildcats power play. So in the early goings, it's been Corpus Christi's PK that has adjusted better from last night as this is dumped in deep by the Cats. First to it here, it's Staub. Looked to leave it there for Bolio. Couldn't find him on a second attempt in the last 90 seconds of the period as we're back to 5-on-5. Rimmed around the boards here. Kruger is out of the box. He had been serving the minor for Kelly. Here's Corpus Christi walking in front here, centered towards the middle, and Cook almost put it in his own net, but he was able to pick this one up. He plays it softly down the ice. Only as far as Cortez in his own zone. Headman pass, lands on the tape of Michaud. Here's Michaud, puts on the brakes, looks to walk up to the middle of the zone. Cortez, loading shot, goes wide of the cage, hammers the back wall. First to it here is Lomsnes. Lomsnes towards the corner once more, hoping for Michaud. First to it there was Townsend. He's walled off it by Kuzin. Digs it loose and worked it along for Oakley. Last minute of play in the period brought to you by La Quinta Inns and Suites. This will not go for icing here. No, it will not go for icing. Litviak down on a knee. Couldn't hook it out in front for Subri. Subri slotted back below the goal line for Litviak. Litviak stashes towards the middle, hoping for Oakley, but he wasn't able to get there. Subri jabs this one on a lunging play up to the blue line. It's Townsend. Townsend softly for Subri. Shot off a leg and goes high and gets the glass. Azenaro now skates towards the corner. Here is Azenaro fed towards the middle. Oakley shot, and he sent it wide. Follow-up is put wide, and that's a soft call, but it's going to be a penalty upcoming against the Wildcats. Down to the ice when Anthony Cortez, or rather Gestro, rather theatrically. Oakley got his stick in there, but it's going to be a tripping call, and the Wildcats, already 0-for-1 on the PK, are going to be shorthanded. After Oakley sent it wide of the cage, he had a great chance from the high slot. And from one end of the spectrum to the other, they go from almost tying things up to having some work to do on the PK. Faceoff will be to the right of Zevnik here. 21.4 seconds remaining in the first as the Cats are shorthanded on the Gilmore's Collision Center penalty kill for the second time tonight. Faceoff. Knight is able to swat this one down the ice, and it will skitter along here as Pickard will leave this one there in the last 10 seconds of the first. So not a first period the Wildcats are going to be too pleased about. Weren't really able to generate a whole lot of definitive scoring chances aside from the one that Oakley put wide there at the end, as this is Cook tying up below the goal line, and that'll draw the horn as we are through 20 minutes here at the Kay Yeager Coliseum. Wildcats trailing 1-0 on a power play goal from Anthony Cortez. Penalty kill will have more work to do when the second period gets going. There's a minute 39 remaining on the penalty to Evan Oakley. We'll step aside. When we come back, we'll hear from Wildcats head coach Sean LaFontaine, and we'll take a look around the North American Hockey League on the Jerry Sporting Goods out-of-town scoreboard. All that and more coming your way just after this on Wildcats Hockey, presented by Armored Roofing here on FastHockey.com and the Wildcats Broadcast Network. Yeager Coliseum. We're through 20 minutes of action here in Wichita Falls as the Wildcats are trailing 1-0. Penalty kill continuing to be a spot where they need improvement, and the power play, which was a boost for them last night, has not been as effective here this evening. 0-2 on the man advantage thus far of the Wildcats, and here's the kicker. No shots on goal in that power play, so I alluded to it in the opening. In the opening segment, that both teams were going to look to improve their penalty kill, and thus far, it seems like the Ice Rays were able to do that. The Wildcats had some trouble with it there, weren't able to clear the zone after about a minute of power play time, and Anthony Cortez let one go from just inside the blue line. As I think Zevnik, if he had to do it all over again, might have been a little bit farther out to challenge and cut down the angle. But as it was, Cortez had a lot of time and space to let that one rip, and Corpus Christi was given some room to operate around the top of the zone. And they're an umbrella power play, are the Ice Rays. So if you give them that time to move around and interchange, it could lead to some things that you're not too happy about. And what it's led to for the Wildcats is a 1-0 deficit. They'll also have another minute 21 of carryover time, rather a minute 39 of carryover time on the PK to start off the second period. So the first test for them will be to finish that one out and see if they can use their splendid seconds to regain control and perhaps gain the lead in this contest. The second period has been a big one for the Wildcats this year as they are outscoring opponents 58-32 in the second. They've scored more goals in the second than they have in any other period this year. They've also allowed fewer goals in the second than any other period this year, so their goal differential in the second is quite impressive. And although I had a chance to talk to Wildcats head coach John LaFontaine earlier today, we talked about the penalty kill, we talked about the 5-on-5, and we also talked about the Wildcats' ability to keep their opponents to the outside. Thus far, they've done a fairly good job of that on the 5-on-5, but Wichita Falls needs to do a little bit better at eliminating the breakaways, which, as we saw last night, led to necessary penalties that had to be taken, and unfortunately led to necessary penalties that had to be taken by some of the Wildcats' best penalty killers. In this case, it was Matt Cook who had to sit 2 minutes as he took a slashing. Zevnik made the toe save on a breakaway by Liliev, but as I alluded to a moment ago, the ensuing power play did not spell good things for the Wildcats. Anyway, we'll hear Wildcats head coach John LaFontaine as I spoke with him earlier today.
Ben Horner with you here, Wildcats fans, and joining me now is Wildcats head coach John LaFontaine as we're talking last night's 5-4 win over the Ice Rays, as well as a quick look ahead to tonight's contest as the two conclude their weekend set, or their Thursday-Friday set, I should say, at the KYC. And John, last night seemed to be a case of neither team able to pull away, and at the end, it was a hard-fought win for the Wildcats, but they did escape with the 2 points. What were your overall thoughts on that performance?
Came away with a lot of good things. Some players that got their game back, got some confidence back. We got to see a new player in Austin Azanero, and wow, you know, everybody came away impressed with him, his first game, and confidence that he showed to want the puck and to want it in critical areas of the ice and not be tentative. I mean, he really impressed us. Yeah, in the end, we couldn't hold a lead or build on it and let them stay close. But you got to be able to win those kind of games. Our PK's got to get better, and we're going to do some changes there. And that's my fault. Running a PK it's not easy to run, a little complicated, and it's other teams have made adjustments to us, and we now need to simplify it and have some better success on the PK from there. But a lot of good things happened last night to get the win. So even though it was close and you get frustrated that we didn't have an easier time with the win, I think it's a good time to build on all the positives and guys that got their game back. I thought Oakley played really strong and was really strong on the wall, and so was Nikita. And Subri was really, you know, those guys were reliable last night and got our game-winning goal. And our other forward lines had some chemistry last night and shots that we haven't put up in a while, that type of number. And if you put up 42 shots, you should be on the winning end.
mentioned the penalty kill there, kind of beat me to the punch, but we'll look at the power play, the positive side of the special teams. 3-for-6 on the man advantage last night. You open the game with 2 power play goals in the first less than 4 minutes of the contest. What was working for the man advantage last night? It's been the theme over the last few weeks, the Wildcats drawing most of their offense from the man advantage.
Yeah, you know, and it's a different unit every night, right? So Knight's unit was clicking last night, and it was great to see Boileau get a strong, really strong game because he's been playing well, just a little snake bit. But they really moved the puck from high to low really well last night. If you think about all the goals we scored, the puck came out high, right back to the goal line, and then either a backdoor pass or a rebound from there for a goal. And those are pretty tough for a PK to stop if you have guys out high that are able to draw them out and then find guys down low. The one goal was a rebound on the back door. So good to see their unit catch fire, and hopefully we can continue to have some success there on the power play.
Special teams dominated the first 2 periods of last night's game, but then it was a 5-on-5 battle through the third. And I said in the intermission heading into the third period that if the Wildcats could clean up the penalties, they would have every shot at coming away with the 2 points, and they were able to do exactly that. What did you make of your team's 5-on-5 play, particularly in the defensive zone? It seems like most of Corpus Christi's offensive chances were generated on their power play opportunities.
Yeah, we were better in the D zone than we have been, and that's an area that we've been focused on. And I think we were better funneling into the D zone, where we're trying to identify and pick up men quicker and be stronger with the man we have off the puck. That's kind of been the theme, and hoping to see that we get better at that so that we're not in our zone and we're not running around. We definitely improved in that area. They got a couple of their goals, obviously, on the power play, and then they got a rush where it was kind of a breakdown at the end there, their fourth goal, where the guy just broke through us, and then the rebound was sitting there. And I thought Austin made a great first save, and we didn't pick up the guy going to the back door, going to the rebound. So that was just a breakdown. It wasn't a defensive zone collapse or anything like that.
You mentioned briefly the new player, number 20, Austin Azzanaro, in his first game last night. Really impressive with the way he slotted in on the Wildcats blue line. Really didn't need too much of an adjustment period coming from Tier 3 up to the Tier 2 level here in the North American Hockey League. What about his game makes him such a valuable addition, or could be a valuable addition for the Wildcats?
He's very explosive. His first couple strides, he just explodes to the puck or separates himself from the forechecker. Made some very smart plays. He knew before he got to the puck what his options were. And defensively, you know, he's got such good feet. He just seemed to be able to adjust and read and know who he needed to pick up and who he needed to box out. But we were very, very impressed with him, and fortunate that we got a call from Marcus, and Marcus did a great job of teaching and helping this young man be ready for this level.
Referring to Marcus Baxter, the head coach and general manager of the Missoula Maulers of the Western States Hockey League, a Tier 3 outfit located mostly in the upper northwest and upper midwest of the U.S. here. And John, let's talk a little bit about the 5-on-5 play just a little bit more here. It had been almost 200 minutes, actually over 200 minutes, since the Wildcats had scored an even strength tally before Jake Townsend ripped one into the back of the net, almost ripped a hole in the net with that big blast from the blue line there. But getting that 5-on-5 goal to kind of break that duck, is that going to be a little bit of a lift heading into tonight's contest?
You know, I think so, Ben. We just seemed like we were bringing the puck to the net more last night, and we had bodies at the net, and we were getting shots through from the point. Our puck movement was better. It just seemed like our game was much more crisp. Our passing was much better. And then down low, we didn't turn the puck over. We were strong down low, and most of the time that generated an opportunity at the net. So, you know, you got to be willing to work harder to get to the tough areas of the ice. We talk about that, the front of the net. You got to pay the price at the front of the net, and you got to pay the price in the corners, and guys were willing to do that last night.
certainly something you're going to have to do against a solid goaltender like Andrew Lindgren. If you don't get traffic in front, he'll snap him out of the air all day long, but seemed to be certainly a point of emphasis for the Wildcats last night. John, thanks for joining us here. We'll step aside. When we come back, we'll look around the league on the Jerry Sporting Goods Out-of-Town Scoreboard Report as Wildcats Hockey presented by Armored Roofing. We'll be back just after this.
All right, you heard Wildcats head coach John LaFontaine speaking with me earlier in the day. Always a good time when I get a chance to catch up with LaFontaine. You can hear his thoughts on every Wildcats game during the first intermission all season long. As now we'll take a look at what else is going on around the North American Hockey League. Pretty full slate tonight as we take a look and dive into the Jerry Sporting Goods Out-of-Town Scoreboard Report. Well, in Flint, Michigan, the Warriors are looking to get back into the win column for the first time in quite some time. The Warriors are hosting the Sioux Eagles in an interstate rivalry. They lead 3-1 through two periods of action. In Wisconsin, the Jets are playing host to the Johnstown Tomahawks, first of two there, as Janesville has won 14 of its last 15 and 11 straight at home, but they are deadlocked at a goal apiece through the first period of play. In Colquitt, Minnesota, the Wilderness playing host to the Aberdeen Wings, first of two games between those two there. Minnesota is 16-3-0 at home, while Aberdeen 6-14-1 at home. Aberdeen currently occupying the fourth and final playoff spot in the Central Division, while the Minnesota Wilderness currently sit in first in the Midwest, 3 points ahead of the Fairbanks Ice Dogs. In Central Pennsylvania, the Keystone Ice Miners are hosting the Springfield Junior Blues. They're in the second period there, about 7 minutes into the second frame, as the Ice Miners, one of the hotter teams in the league right now, are leading 1-0. How about this for Keystone? They have won 7 of their last 8 since news broke that the team would be folding at the end of the year. Talk about a little bit of extra motivation. They've been on quite the hot spell. In Brookings, it's 2-1. The Bruins on the road leading the Blizzard. I beg your pardon. As later on tonight, the Minnesota Magicians will be facing off with the Minot Minotauros. Fairbanks will play host to the Wenatchee Wild, and Kenai River will host the Cooley Region for the first of three. Around the league in the South Division, in Odessa, the Jackalopes are opening up a two-game set against the Amarillo Bulls. Bulls leading 2-1 at the end of one period of play there at the Ector County Coliseum. In Topeka at the Landon Arena, no score between the Roadrunners and the Rio Grande Valley Killer Bees. Just underway in the first period there, as that's a battle for the Bees to try and keep pace with Amarillo for the sixth and final playoff spot in the South Division. The idle team this evening in the South are the Lone Star Brahmas. They will not play again until the Wildcats make the short trip down to North Richland Hills next Friday and Saturday. That's the Jerry Sporting Goods Out-of-Town Scoreboard, and that's the intermission show. We'll step aside when we come back. We'll have the second period of action here from the Kay Yeager Coliseum. The Wildcats will start it off with a minute 39 of carryover penalty time to deal with on the tripping minor to Evan Oakley. Can they kill it off and mount a comeback? Stick around and find out after the break on FastHockey.com and the Wildcats Broadcast Network. Kay Yeager Coliseum. Second period of action dead ahead between the Wildcats and the Corpus Christi IceRays. Rays holding a 1-0 lead on a power play goal in the first period by Anthony Cortez past a screened Zevnik, as the Wildcats will be shorthanded for the first minute 39 of this second period as they'll look to finish off the kill and try and keep this deficit right here at one goal. It's Oakley serving a tripping minor as the two teams will change ends. Zevnik now in the cage to our left as the Cats skate left to right across your screen. That's P to Q, or Q to P across your keyboard, beg my pardon, as coming back the other way are the Ice Rays wearing their black sweaters as Luke Pickar is in the cage to our right. It was 1 versus 30 last night for Austin Shaw and Andrew Lindgren. It's 1 versus 30 tonight, just flip-flopped, with Luke Pickar number 1 for the Rays and Zevnik number 30 for the Wildcats. Having a little bit of a ice maintenance session here in the crease of David Zevnik as the linesman trying to freeze things up here. Of course, the Wildcats certainly know all about ice issues in the crease. Think back to that game back in Rio Grande Valley that the Wildcats are going to have to finish at some point. We still don't know exactly what the sequence is going to be for that. Not sure if the crease is good to go here. Looks like it is. So it will be Anderson getting set to drop the puck here between Michaud and Farmer as the Wildcats start off on the penalty kill in this second period. Cam Knight, Staub, Farmer, and Matt Cook, the guys out there for Wichita Falls on the Gilmore Collision Center penalty kill, and the puck is down. We're underway in the first period, or in the second period, as this one is sent the length of the ice by Cam Knight to start off the second frame. Back to collect and looking to start forward for the Ice Rays here is Anthony Cortez. As a goal to his credit thus far, drop pass here is skated onto by Ryan Kuzin. Stick handles through some space, now plays it off to the side wall where it was taken by Gio Schmeely. Gratefully wrapped around the boards there by the Ice Rays, Lomzis left it into the corner where it's taken by Michaud. Michaud hacks it down low. Gio Schmeely looks to walk up ahead. Couldn't play it up to the point, so we'll give it down low where Lomzis is tangled up with Cam Knight. Fed off to the far side wall. Colin Saab trying to race to meet it there. He was able to skip that one free, and it skates just over the blue line. As now here is Colin Staub shorthanded, trying to get around Gio Schmeely. Staub with a backhander that floated wide of the cage. Shorthanded, Farmer will go in on the forecheck near side. About a minute played in this second period. 45 seconds remaining in the penalty to Evan Oakley, as pulling this one free is Gio Schmeely. Liking the drop pass now are the Ice Rays as it's dropped back between the legs for Cortez. Now Michaud, toe drag shot, fought off there. Rebound picked up here by Michaud. Michaud leaves this one at the point where it's Cortez. Now fed back to the middle of the blue line. Here's Michaud holding on it. Trades places with Kuzin there, directing traffic. Kuzin gives this one along to Cortez. Nice keep there by Cortez. Finds Michaud now. Here's Michaud. Drops it back. Here's Cortez. Walks into one. Back door. They score. It's Lomsness on the power play. Someone fell asleep on the weak side, and the Wildcats give up another power play goal. That is their fourth power play goal allowed on the weekend, and they trail 2-0. Lomsness gets his third goal of the weekend. That one just floated into the back of the net. Zevnik might have gotten a piece, but either way, the Wildcats continue to struggle on the penalty kill, and it continues to hurt them. Back to play here at 5-on-5. Let's see if the Wildcats can respond. Falconer will play it towards the corner. The Wildcats are going to need an immediate response here to keep the Ice Rays from starting to put a stranglehold on this one as this is played down towards the corner. Sherrison canceled out with it there, but pulling it back free was Eric Yeager. Yeager left it there, hoping for Sherrison, getting involved here with Sherrison. It's banked up the wall. Kuzmeski couldn't handle it cleanly, slept for it there, wasn't able to get there. Galloping forward, here's Chitwood with a step-around bomb. Backhander fought off by Zevnik, and he punched away the rebound as well. Quickly up the ice, it was Yeager hoping for it, but instead it worked its way along to Jestro, into the glove of Zevnik. He'll spike it back down to the ice, where it's picked up here by the Wildcats in the form of Kuzmeski. Kuzmeski wipes out here, but he was able to force this one in deep. Now it's Yeager looking to split the D, fights through the slashing minor. Someone went down to the ice. This is held in here. Sherrison holding. Now another quick shot. They score! Sherrison into the top corner. A 5-on-5 goal, and the Wildcats pull one back. It's 2-1 now. Sherrison gets his 20th of the year. He held on a shot then let it go. I think that pump fake was just enough to get Pickard down in his butterfly and open up some space top shelf, and the Wildcats get the response they needed. Face off here. We're back to play. Wildcats with almost an immediate response, and they needed it from Sherazin. Cortez, big rebound here, spiked away from danger, and Jessica will take this one behind the net. First to it here on the near side. The Ice Rays winning the battle along the wall right now. Below the goal line here is Jessica. He left it behind here as Cook will take this for Wichita Falls. Rimmed around the kick plate for Risinger. Risinger ridden into the wall awkwardly there. He'll lose out as coming forward here is Corpus Christi. Got lost in the skates of the referee there as Kruger was upended and unhappy. Now it's Cook. Fed up ahead here is Risinger. Walks towards the middle. Chipped in front for Staub, who wasn't expecting it there. Looking over the wrong shoulder was Collin as he'll skate it off to the far side wall. Tied up there along the hash marks there. A two-a-side battle ensues as Lazarus and Staub are in there. Held up to the point. Here is Matt Cook. Cook towards the net. Thrown in front. Delayed penalty upcoming here against Corpus Christi. Risinger touching up here is Jestro and will get the whistle. So 16:36 remaining in the second period. A cross-checking minor is going to be assessed here to Anthony Cortez. And if he's not careful, he's going to get a 10-minute misconduct, kind of looking at the referee like, what do you want me to do? And Krasichuk, the referee, says, I want you to skate to the box. That's what I want you to do. So Cortez will serve 2 minutes for a cross-check. The Wildcats 0 for 2 on the power play will get back to work here on the third attempt of the night. They were 3 for 6 on the man advantage as the league's leading power play unit. We'll go back to work looking to tie this contest up. On the air, the Wildcats, 26.7% on the man advantage. That's 39 for 146. Off the faceoff here, trying to dig it free and hold the zone was Collin Staub. He'll skip this one along the yellow kick plane at the bottom of the wall. Townsend steps down into the corner here, as does Apap, as it works its way all the way up. Now it's Townsend. He'll skate up the wall and reverse down low. Apap slung it cross ice, nobody home, as Staub skates over and sends this up to Cam Knight. Now it's Staub wheeling towards the middle. Here is Bolio back in front. Staub, and he fanned on it. Puck is loose, and it's sent all the way down the ice. You're not going to see Collin Staub fan on that chance too many times as he was looking to pick the top corner, as that was a great setup between Knight, Staub, and Bolio. Here is the aforementioned Staub from the aforementioned Knight. Here is Staub. He'll look to chip this one towards the net there as he got to the corner. Now he's tied up. Couldn't go up to the point with it. It's on the stick of the Ice Rays in the form of Lomzis, who gets it up ahead to Michaud shorthanded. Spiked away from him there alertly by Cam Knight. Bolio settles, tries to lead it up ahead for Farmer. Farmer trying to race through the check here of Spillum as Risinger holds his own and couldn't find Farmer there. It was all alone in front. Farmer trying to fight to the check of Jestro. Risinger getting involved there. Farmer pulls this one free. Along the wall is Farmer. Chips it up, hoping to get it up to the point. It never got there. Risinger ties his man up along the far side. Squirted here free by Jestro, and he'll bounce it all the way down the ice, and the Wildcats will get a change going. Remaining in the second period. Zebnik left this one there for Matt Cook. 30 seconds remaining in the Wildcats' power play, which is looking better on this attempt here, but still nothing to show for it. First to it here is going to be Huser, and he'll send this one all the way down the ice. Not a good dump in there by Cook. He'll hang his head as he skates back to corral it. Putting him under some pressure is Breyer. Cook, in the last 18 seconds of the power play, Jaeger led this one in stride. Sherazin couldn't handle it cleanly, so Jaeger will take this one back in his own zone. We'll be back to 5-on-5 in the next 8 seconds. Cook gains the zone, looks to set up shop. Softly along here, Subar drop past Chairs, and now it's Risinger shot. They score! Risinger with 1 second remaining on the power play. The Cats have scored 2 unanswered. And this one is tied up 2 apiece. Risinger from an acute angle on the power play just tucked it inside the far side post after Subri had passed up a chance and dropped it for Sherazin. It handcuffed Sherazin, but he was able to move it along for Max, and Max swept it home for goal number 14 of the year. Oh, the second period's continuing to be a boost for the Wildcats thus far. 5.5 minutes gone in the second, and we're back to where we started. Even score as Baum works this one along. Oakley has some trouble with it here. He'll skate through some traffic, lose out on the puck. Coming along to reinforce here was Subri, and this one pinballs around, and Subri will send it the length of the ice. Here's Oakley, softly towards the net. Worked its way over the outstretched glove of an IceRays skater. Litviak protecting. Slung across ice. Here's Kuzmeski. Loading shot. Blocked. Oakley shot. Saved there by Picker. And he couldn't cover the rebound. Oakley, a hungry player tonight, fed towards the middle, held in nicely by Baum. Baum puts it on his backhand and rolls it down the glass, where Subri swept it along for Oakley. Oakley, tied up here by Carl, left along here as Subri kicks it free. Subri looks to trade places with Oakley. Now it's Subri looking to stash towards the middle. On his backhand, he'll go up the wall. Kuzmeski sends it right back down low. Little hot for Litviak to handle now as the Wildcats starting to warm to the task here as Baum on a good pinch down the blue line holds his own. Litviak has it in his skates, bumped down from behind. No call upcoming here. This one cleared, punched along into the neutral zone by Kuzmeski as the Wildcats maintain possession. APAP just outside the offensive zone. Chips this one towards the cage of Picar. First to it here will be Bolio. A couple of guys wipe out here below the goal line. It's APAP trying to spin towards the middle there. He'll collect and get to the point. Here is Townsend. Holds on it. Walks back towards the wall now. Townsend towards the net off a leg and goes wide. Jaeger first to it here below the goal line. Hooked towards the middle and everyone was down below the goal line. If someone was in front, it could have been a tap-in. Now it could be a 2-on-1 offside play here against the IceRays as they will let the Wildcats repossess as they'll tag up. Townsend now. We've played just over 7 minutes in this second period. Here's Azenaro, headman pass. He was hoping for APAP. This is going to go for icing against the Wildcats. Low 45 remaining in this second period. It sprung to life here in the middle frame at the KYC. Ben Horner with you on FastHockey.com and the Wildcats Broadcast Network. A power play tally from Lobsness at a minute 25 of the second to give the IceRays a 2-0 lead has been canceled out by Kevin Sherrison and Max Reisinger. An even strength goal and a power play goal, respectively. All of those tallies happening in the first 5 minutes and 23 seconds of the frame. Played up to the point. Gestro swept it along. Here is Cortez. Shot scores! I think Zevnik was screened. It might have been interfered with again. Too deep in his net was Zevnik. Never got out above the blue paint. He's got to challenge that shot more. And Cortez gets his second of the night. He snuck it through traffic, did Cortez. Zevnik. If he didn't have much chance on the first one, he certainly should have done a little bit better there. He needed some help from someone to clear out the traffic in front, but he was also not nearly far enough out above his crease. And that's something that when Zevnik is not going well, you can tell because he's not out challenging the puck. We'll keep an eye on that one here as gaining the zone. Here's Staub as he forced a turnover. Staub hoped to lead it along for Reisinger. Instead, it's turned over here. Chips softly forward by Howe. First onto this one here as Zevnik steps out of his crease. Reisinger cancels his man out. Kicked along by Colin Staub as he'll start it up 2-3. Staub gains his own. Left it along. Lazarus kicked it towards the net of Picar there. As this one is swept along, sent all the way down the ice. Will it go for icing? No, it will not. Not sure why. 12 minutes remaining in the second. Cortez's second of the night has canceled out the Wildcats' good work. Turned over here. Bad giveaway by Matt Cook, but the Wildcats are going to get away with it for the time being as Lazarus swats this one forward. Reisinger will chase this one down. Now comes to the bench for a change. 11:45 remaining in the second period. Up the ice it comes. This is Matt Cook. Having some trouble with it there, but Farmer will move it along for Kuzmeski. Here's Kuzmeski at the red line. Banked it forward for Sherrison. Sherrison led along. Tries to find a teammate there. A couple of guys cancel out, and Michaud has it, but put it right on the stick of Sherrison. Sherrison got it back for Baum, who plays it off to the far side. Kuzmeski galloping along. Here's Kuzmeski holding. Looks to play in front for Sherrison. It was intercepted. Chip towards the middle, and Farmer was canceled out. Farmer will chase. Into the corner he goes. Kicked along here, but Falconer will hold the zone. Lost out on the near side wall as Sherrison wasn't able to hold it along either. Sherrison will come back and get this one. Played it back for Kuzmeski. Kuzmeski will take it behind the cage and bump it off the back wall as Kuzin was in on a hard forecheck. Falconer looked to sweep this one along for Jeff Baum. Now Baum below the goal line here. Moves it off for Kuzmeski. Kuzmeski's pass up ahead. Sherrison led through the middle of the ice. Falconer steps onto a broken play. Here is Falconer now. His shot blocked and caromed away here. Now look out. Azenaro. It's a 2-on-0. Here is Giosvili in front for Breyer, and they score. It's a broken play. The Cats get burned on a change. Not getting the puck deep. More of the Wildcats. And they gift a transition chance to the IceRays, and Corpus Christi takes advantage. Oh, the Wildcats score two, then give two right back. And Zevnik's night is done. Austin Shaw will come in, and Zevnik did not look his best. Shaw had started in five straight games. Coach LaFontaine went away from him, and the Wildcats didn't get the performance they were hoping to from Zevnik, as now they're going to need a big performance here from the defense and the offense. They're trailing 4-2 to an IceRays squad that is averaging barely two goals a game on the road. 10:36 remaining in the second, still a whole lot of time left, and the Wildcats can score in bunches. We've seen that this year, but they need to get better about shoring up those breakaway and transition chances there, as that one was just a broken play. Azenaro was left in no man's land. He was trying to sprint over from the bench. It's the period of the long change for the Wildcats here. And again, they're not able to get this one deep. Again, coming forward, here's Lomzis. Drops it there, looking to walk towards the front of the net, swept away from danger, as this is Townsend. Turned over, though. Cortez on a hat trick, and his slap shot blocked in front by Azenaro. Now it's along for Gestro. He held it in, barely shot. Goes well wide of the cage. Kuzin into the middle of the ice behind Lomzis, and Oakley will pick this one up for Wichita Falls. Oakley softly forward. No icing here as Litviak will win this one down low. Touch towards the middle there. Ramped up off the back of the cage. Loose in front. Litviak trying to dig for it there, and he wasn't able to reach this one first. Here is Liliev softly behind. Oakley ridden off it there. The blind reverse was on for Litviak, but he didn't hear the call, as this is Azenaro gloving it down in his own zone. Moved it along for Townsend. Townsend up the ice, hoping for a teammate there. Eluded everyone. APAP lost his lumber, as this one is on the stick of Azenaro once more. Up ahead for Jaeger. Intercepted by the IceRays. Onside, here is Liliev with a quick shot for Cortez. Rebound doesn't get all the way through, as this was Kuzin trying to bank it home on a short angle chance. Holding the zone and playing towards the middle there was Liliev. Wildcats having some trouble in their own zone. They're running around a little bit like chickens with their heads cut off, as APAP picks this one up and looks to bank this one forward. He does. Now he looks to lunge it towards the middle. Puck loose there, and Bolio had a short chance, and it was turned aside. He was in close, but we will get a whistle, and it'll be a hooking minor against the IceRays. 9:07 remaining in the second. The Wildcats will head back to the power play. They are 1-for-3 on the man advantage tonight. So the Wildcats tied things up with two goals in 3 minutes exactly, and then it took less than 2 minutes for them to give Griff Jeska and Nathan Breyer a goal. I believe that goal was actually Breyer's, not Jeska. Either way, well, actually, they gave Cortez's second to Jeska. Anyway, the Cats are trailing 4-2, but they're on the power play for the fourth time tonight. Matt Cook wasn't able to work it along to a teammate there, as Reisinger was waiting on the near side. So Cook will have to chase it back there. Eludes Lomzis below the goal line, and now motors up ahead. Here is Farmer gaining the zone. Drops it here as Sherazin, fed towards the middle. Cook, slap shot, fought off in front there by Picard. Farmer couldn't get it back up to Cook there at the point, as Sherazin will have to play this one in his own zone. That is too many men on the ice against the IceRays. Plain as day, Wildcats bringing it in. Jaeger, his centering feed there was canceled out by a sprawled out Carl, as the IceRays should have been whistled for too many men on the ice, but that was a generous call by the linesman. Either way, here is Jaeger. Here is Cook now. Blue line holding shot, save wide of the cage. Bank attempt. Farmer scores! It was tucked out in front. Sherazin helped it along, and Farmer just skittered it 5-hole, and the Cats pull one back again. Farmer trickled it home after Cook's shot caromed off the back wall. It's 4-3, and the Cats once more have life. 8:21 remaining in the second period, as this one just rolled through the 5-hole before Picard could reach back and sweep it away. So, goal number 16 on the year for Nick Farmer, as the Wildcats trail by one for the third time tonight. 8:10 remaining in the second period. This one is played all the way down the ice, as hustling back to grab it was Jake Townsend. Townsend Can't work it up the wall there. Got some help as Howe left this one along to his counterpart, Paul Soubry. Howe wins this one back in the corner. Azenaro trying to work it along there. To his side, battle ensues inside the last 8 minutes of the second period here at the King Yeager Coliseum as this one has sprung to life in this middle frame. 3 goals apiece, but the Wildcats are trailing. They turned it over here as this is barely held in onside, but it's pitchforked well up and out of play by Kruger, who is off balance, and that will get the whistle and a faceoff in the neutral zone. 7:43 remaining in the second period. The Wildcats trailing 4-3. They have scored three in this second, but so have the Ice Rays. Sherazin, Reisinger, and Farmer for the Cats. Lomsness, Cortez, and Breyer for the Ice Rays. Faceoff will be in the neutral zone here. Wildcats trying to pull this one free. This is Staub looking to hack it forward, left behind. Reisinger works it along. Lazarus chipping for a loose puck here, but it's settled down by the Ice Rays in the form of Crenon. Haven't called Crenon's name too much tonight. This sent all the way down the ice. Gio Schvili got to stick to it, so no icing here as Shaw will sweep this one along here. Off the far side wall, that was Colford taking it for the Ice Rays. Colford takes this one right back. Nice stick by Kuzmeski. He lost it in his skates, however. Turns it over. Quick shot. Glove save there by Shaw. Good sharp glove hand there by the Colorado native after the Wildcats had some trouble escaping their own zone. 7:12 remaining in the second period. The Wildcats are trailing 4-3. They have the penalty kill to thank for the time being. They've given up 2 power play goals to the Ice Rays on 2 shorthanded chances on the Gilmore's Collision Center penalty kill. Zevnik was not at the races tonight. He has been relieved. Austin Shaw is in the game. If you're just joining us, well, you've missed a good 30-plus minutes or so in the opening stages of this contest. The Wildcats trailing 4-3, but this third period has seen the game explode to life after a fairly cagey first period. That only saw just the one goal. When we get back to play here, as we're in immediate timeout, the faceoff will be to the left of Austin Shaw, who is getting some in-game coaching from Chris Saransky there, discussing something and some positioning. Shaw, let's get you his numbers on the year. 16-5-0 with a .274 goals against average and a .907 save percentage. Off will be to the left of the aforementioned Shaw here. Kuzin. It's one here by the Wildcats, left behind by Yeager, however. Jabbed along to the near side as this is Tommy Apap. Apap pitchforks this one forward. It's skated onto here by Kuzin. Kuzin through the middle of the ice is passed red and intercepted by Cam Knight, who will drop it back and give it forward now for Matt Cook to start the rush. Cook, nice little stick move here, but he overskated. He'll get it back, leads it forward, skates into the zone. Here's Matt Cook. Shot steered aside there, picked up on the far side wall by Yeager. Softly down low for Bolio. Bolio spinning away. Here's Bolio. He'll leave it there and give to Yeager. Yeager on his backhander couldn't get it towards the middle of the ice, as this is Cam Knight trying to hold the zone, and he was just able to get in front of Kuzin to keep Kuzin from racing away. Turned over here, though, as Michaud will hold the zone as Cook couldn't get to that puck. Fed up to the blue line. Slap shot. Save. Puck is loose. Shaw covers up and it's cleared off the line. Swept from the blue paint by an alert Wildcat skater. Apap, oh, coming together here as Yeager and Lomsness are tangled up. Cats will gain the zone in the form of Apap. Apap ridden into the corner there as now he's ridden off as Carl will move this one forward. Carl up ahead for Michaud with Azenaro in front of him. Michaud chips it off to Liliev. Liliev in the corner. Liliev fed towards the middle here. It's held in at the point and fed towards the corner. First to it here below the goal line was Liliev. Fed towards the middle once more. Splits everybody and goes all the way down the ice. Stepping out to play this one, there was Pickard. He did so. The Wildcats have to tag up on a delayed offside. Farmer will float this one high and in deep as Sherazin tags up at the blue line. Last, not out. Sherrison holds it in at the left wing side. Play towards the front of the net. Falconer reaches and corrals. Here is Falconer now, looking to play towards the corner. Sherrison swept it along. Farmer waits for it to get to him, spins off the check, and plays up to the point. Here is Townsend. Now it's Azenaro. Settles, gives back to Townsend, holding on his shot. Azenaro wants it. He'll get it. Here's Azenaro into the middle. Here's Farmer jabbing forward. He lost the puck, throws it down to the ice, as touched up here by the Ice Rays. No hand pass. Here is Townsend. Gives it to Oakley, fresh from the bench. Shot blocked there, lost in the paraphernalia, and Oakley gets it back. Stumbles, but corrals once more anyway. Farmer, one-timer blocked in front, skittering around here, and reaching and pushing it to the wall was Sherrison. Sherrison up to the point. Now we'll spin back and give it to Oakley. Under his stick, Huser rolls this one around the boards. Kelly chops it free, and it escapes the reach of Azenaro and goes down the ice. Good shift there from the Wildcats. 4:40 remaining in the second period. Litviak walking through some traffic. Here's Nikita Litviak now walking all the way in. Litviak in front, shot, floats high and goes over the bar. Fed towards the middle, and Subri wasn't able to catch it cleanly. He wasn't expecting the pass so quickly. Here is Kuzmeski back in his own zone in the last 4:25 of a second period. That sees Subri play this one forward for Litviak. Offside here as Oakley wasn't able to hold the zone. 4:19 remaining in the second period. The Wildcats are trailing 4-3. Staub will take the draw in front of his own bench. Farmer out there with him instead of APAP. Farmer, coincidentally, playing in his 150th game as a member of the Wildcats. Reisinger kicked this one along and played it in deep as he was standing at the blue line. Crenon hammered it off the wall. Didn't escape the zone, though, as this is picked up by the Ice Rays. Knife down, but goes out of play. Where will they put the faceoff? As it went into the Wildcats zone. There's 4:04 remaining in the second period. Face-off right in front of the Wildcats bench area in the neutral zone. 4:04 remaining in the second period, and the Wildcats certainly wanting to get this one tied up at the very least heading into the second period, as the Ice Rays are 13-0-1 when leading after two periods of play. Headman pass looking for Giosvili escapes his reach as Cam Knight having some trouble there, but he was able to work it free, and Reisinger moved it along. Here's Staub. Hard back to the near side. He was hoping for Farmer. Rather, that was Matt Cook, and that one is spiked out of play. We'll get the faceoff in the neutral zone once more. We'll stick around in the second period, which is just 3 minutes and 46 seconds of game time away, as we'll revisit last night's 5-4 win in a back-and-forth affair here at the KYC. The Wildcats hoping to replicate the result with a win here. They're trailing 4-3 as this is Cook wiring it off the glass and in. APAP has some trouble with it there as this is off to the far side where Chitwood looks to chip this one free. Held in nicely by Yeager. He'll play it down towards the corner. Glove down by Cook, fed towards the middle of the ice, swept away there from Bolio. Now it's a 2-on-0. Here's Giosvili. In front is Chitwood. Giosvili wasn't able to get there first. That one was skittering away as the Wildcats let two guys sneak behind him, but they got away with it. Cook pulls this one free. There's 3:10 remaining in the second period. His pass hard to the near side. Intercepted. APAP back along for Matt Cook. He's at the end of his shift, as is everyone else, and the Wildcats will start up a full change in the last 3 minutes of the second period. Headman pass, then all the way down the ice. Townsend wasn't able to glove it here. Azenaro first back to it here. Off the outside of the cage of Shaw. Poked towards the middle there. Below the goal line, it's Colford looking to bank in front. And Shaw was alert to it here as the Wildcats move forward. This is Falconer. Falconer right down the middle. Chips wide of the cage and goes in after it as Sherrison is there as well. Falconer and Sherrison aren't able to win this puck free as Giosvili, rather Kanon, moved it ahead to Michaud. Here's Michaud with Lomzis in the middle. Michaud through the blue paint there and out the other side. Now Kuzin into the corner for Lomsnes. Lomsnes, nice hip check there by Azenaro, fed in front, hoping for Michaud, but it's swept away. Now back towards the front of the net. Farmer got a stick in the way there, and Townsend picks this one up at the far side wall. Banked out by Townsend. Sent back in deep by the Ice Rays. No icing here in the last 2:10 of the second period. Headman pass intercepted here by as Azenaro put it right into the body of Michaud. Michaud, one move too many there as he was toe-dragging. He lost out on the puck. Litviak lost out as well. Toe drag at the blue line again. This is Kuzin this time. He lost out on the puck as Azenaro chips it back around for Townsend. Townsend through the middle. It's Subri now. Subri up ahead for Litviak. Did he get a stick to it here? Yes, that negates the icing. Litviak and Gestro tangle up and going hard to the boards together. Both are back to their feet as it's loose below the goal line. Trying to dig it free. It's Subri. Subri canceled out here in the corner. He'll sweep it back behind. Litviak interfered with there. We'll play on. Suppose that's a bit of karma for that big collision. Here's Oakley trying to walk towards the middle there. Lost out, but holds it. Holds the zone. Here is Subri, fed to the middle of the ice, hoping for Oakley. Glove down here, but Baum holds his own for the Wildcats. This is Subri. On his backhand, he'll sweep down low. Oakley there getting involved, trying to get involved as well, was Risinger, fresh from the bench. Subri tries to go right back for Risinger, but instead it's glassed down by the Ice Rays. Kuzmeski will hustle out here. Shaw put under some pressure, so he'll play it along. Gestro wide of the cage there, and the last minute of play in the period brought to you by La Quinta Inns and Suites. Kuzmeski reaching for it there, lost out on the puck. Shot goes wide of the cage. Shaw saw it late, but no harm, no foul, as Lazarus sends this one the length of the ice. This caroms towards the cage of Pickard, but will be icing here against the Cats with 44.4 seconds remaining in the second period. 4-3 the score in this second period. The Wildcats are trailing. Corner with you on fasthockey.com and the Wildcats Broadcast Network. As the Cats have put on a good push here, for sure, they've been a little bit lucky at times, as this is a slap shot, save, rebound, they score! Shaw was tangled up as Baum did not clear out the man in front. And the two-goal lead restored for the Ice Rays. Loose puck was swept home. Shaw was tangled up. They must have thought it was by their own defensemen, the referees, because they let that one stand. Shaw had no chance to play that puck. And it's 5-3. The icing burns the Wildcats. 38.9 seconds remaining in the second period. They trail by two. And wide of the cage, the Wildcats are just not playing well enough in their defensive zone right now. The PK is still hurting them as well in the last 30 seconds of the period. Here is Matt Cook. Cook will look to bring it forward, holding shot off of his stick and goes up and out of play in the last 19.9 remaining in the second period. Bolio having a coming together here. So the pairing of Kuzmeski and Baum is having some trouble here this evening. Not the first time tonight off that one that we saw the D pairing not able to handle the traffic in front. The Ice Rays are sticking to the same script from the first period, and the Cats are not adjusting right now. We'll see if they're able to do that in the third, as they're going to need something big here to avoid their third loss of the season here, or their fourth loss of the season at the KYC. Fifth loss, third time was a charm. Anyway, Cronon moves this one along in the last 10 seconds of the frame, as this is Apap playing this one deep, bumped down hard. Bolio comes back to the blue line to tag up, gets worked over a little bit there, and will get the horn in the last second of the period, as there it goes. So the Wildcats score three in the frame, but they give up another four to the Ice Rays on some sloppy play on the penalty kill and on a couple of broken line changes there. As coming together after the fact, Bolio getting tied up there by Michaud. Krasichuk, the referee, trying to separate everyone here. And both teams will skate off to their locker rooms with the Wildcats having some thinking to do. We'll step aside when we come back. We'll have the intermission report and highlights from last night's game and a look around the league on the Jerry Sporting Goods out-of-town scoreboard. That and more coming your way after this on FastHockey.com and the Wildcats Broadcast Network. Yeager Coliseum. The Wildcats are trailing 5-3 through 40 minutes of action with 20 more minutes remaining. And, well, they've just been sloppy. The penalty kill is 0-2 on the night. That's been a big problem for the Wildcats over the last few weeks. And also not good enough in their defensive zone. And what we've seen the Wildcats get plagued with over the last few weeks and at the beginning of the month, they're scoring goals, but giving them away far too quickly. The Wildcats need to shore up on the defensive side of the puck. The offense is there, but they need to do better on defense. Guys are trying to get a little too aggressive. We saw a 2-on-0, a 3-on-1, and almost 3-on-0. I mean, it's been basically off to the races for the Ice Rays thus far, and the Wildcats are going to need to do something to settle this one down and get this game under control. They're getting outshot 17-12 in this contest, according to Point Streak, and if that holds, the Wildcats, or if that is accurate, the Wildcats are well on pace for their lowest output of the season in terms of shots on goals. And it's six shots on goal per period. Yeesh. Not exactly what you're thinking the Wildcats are going to be able to do, a team that averages 35.6 shots on goal per game. Anyway, though, there's still 20 minutes left to go at the King Yeager Coliseum, and anything can happen. Last night was a wild one, as the Wildcats are going to be hoping that this one will have a wild finish to it as well. But first, before we can get into the third period, we'll flash back to last night. It will be Nathan Breyer going against Tommy Apap in the draw, and the puck is down as we are underway in the first period, brought to you by American Classified. It's Matt Cook playing this one along for Cam Knight. Just over 2 minutes played in the first period, no score as the Wildcats are on the first power play of the game. Knight gallops forward, looks to play off to the right wing corner where this is going to be Machad trying to clear. Townsend swallowed it up in his belly and holds his own. Now it's Knight looking to play out in front. Beaulieu scores! Austin Beaulieu breaks the duck. The Wildcats get a power play goal, and they're going to go right back on it as there was a delayed penalty upcoming. Beaulieu on the power play makes it 1-0. That is his 18th goal of the year and his first in his last 8 games. I mentioned those power plays or those penalty kill struggles for the IceRays over their last 8 games, just 21-for. And that's 70%. Here's Beaulieu, top of the left wing circle, takes it in some space. Now down low, here's Staub, hooked out in front there. Backhander, they score! They scored! That's 100 points for Colin Staub on the assist, and the Cats lead 2-0. Someone get that puck for Colin. That's the century mark for Staub, and the Cats lead 2-0. Cortez, he'll walk towards the middle. Cortez, near side now for Lamsis, outside the circle. Into the corner where Machad will grab it. Wheeling up towards the top of the zone. Here's Machad, played out in front, they score! What a setup there. It was played to Ryan Kuzin, who pulls one back and makes it 2-1. This one is floated wide of the cage here as Corpus Christi will come in on the forecheck. Play towards the front of the net there, trailing play. Here's Cortez, hooked towards the middle there, and I think Azenaro got a stick in front as the Wildcats look to start a breakout. Could be a 2-on-1. It's Lazarus with Staub. Lazarus holding shot, saved there by Lindgren. Lazarus floated in front there. Risinger couldn't hack it home on a baseball swing. Now it's towards the front of the net, and Lazarus has a poke at it, but Lindgren covers up. It's Apap. Apap protects up to the blue line where it's held in by Cam Knight. Had to take it off his skate. Now wheels towards the middle. Along for Beaulieu, top of the left circle. Holding on it. Now walks towards the middle. Shot wide. Rebound is on the stick of Colin Staub below the goal line. Here's Staub. Chipped along for Townsend outside the right circle. Here is Townsend. Up to the blue line for Cam Knight. Now it's Beaulieu at the left point. Beaulieu holds. Shakes to the middle. Here is Knight. Shot. Backdoor scores! Colin Staub on the power play. No doubt about that one. The Wildcats reclaim the 2-goal lead. It's Staub on the man advantage. It's 3-1. Top of the circle. Drop pass. Kuzin gets it back again. Kuzin down towards the corner. High slot. Cortez walks into one. Slap shot. Scores. It was tipped in front. Pulling the trigger in the circle was Michaud. And it's 3-2. A power play tally once more for the Ice Rays cuts the deficit. First do it here. Mario back there on defense. Lomsnes hooks towards the middle. Backhand shot. Doesn't get all the way through, coming from the stick of Jeska. Rather, that was Jestro. Squirts out to the far side wall. Lomsnes chopping at this one. Worked it free. Fed for Kuzin. Here's Kuzin walking in front. Saved there by Shaw. Point blank. Cleared. Not out. Here is Cortez. Now towards the front of the net there from Lomsnes. And this is picked up by the Wildcats in the form of Jaeger. He'll get to the red line and play this in deep. Scher is in fresh from the bench. We'll head in after it on the forecheck here as the Cats are in the midst of a change. Shaw with the first big save of the third period here on a chance in front for Kuzin. Towards the middle there. Karam's up to the blue line. Townsend, one-timer, scores! Oh, big blast from the blue line. The veteran Townsend with a bolt from the blue out of nothing. The Wildcats lead 4-2. The Cats now leading 3-2. Up the ice here. Townsend wasn't able to keep this one out of the zone. Michaud shot directed away there easily enough as Lomsnes looks to go back towards the middle. Cronon shot scores. Tipped in front there. It was Lomsnes getting his second of the night, and it's 4-3. Win by Zanaro. Won it back to the point. Cook towards the net. Deflected rebound. They score. It's Paul Soubry in front of the net along with Oakley, and the Wildcats stretch their lead back to 2 again. It's 5-3. Here is Lipiak, tied up once more in the corner. Lipiak can't jab this one down low. Now he'll try to tie up as a two-a-side battle will ensue as Soubry comes along to support. Lipiak hauled down to the ice, lost out on it as Colford took it and worked it up ahead to Gioschvili. Now to Chitwood looking to. Chitwood, he does. Chitwood, save, rebound, they score. Chitwood split the D. Shaw made the save. No one picked up Gioschvili on the backhand, on the back check. And it's 5-4. So as soon as this puck is dropped, for all intents and purposes, Kelly will be out of the box. Kelly is out of the box and will join the rush immediately here. He gets involved. Liljev tries to chip it past Jaeger. Jaeger tied up here. He hooked off Liljev. No call forthcoming. Liljev looking to wrap around in front, and it was sent wide of the cage. Liljev holding on this one. Grade A chance goes begging. Will they take advantage on a second attempt? Here is Carl towards the net. Blocked down in front there by Matt Cook. Face up. One towards the middle. Here is Cortez from the circle. Shot, save, rebound. No bat for it. It's still loose and cleared away, but not down. Now it's on the stick of APAP with 3 seconds remaining. 2-1, and the horn will sound. The Wildcats didn't make it pretty. They didn't make it easy, but they made it 2 points here tonight for Wichita Falls. They got out the 5-4 win over the Corpus Christi Ice Rays to open this two-game set on a Thursday night. Jaeger Coliseum. Ben Horner with you on FastHockey.com and the Wildcats Broadcast Network. Wildcats are trailing 5-3 here, and they might be undoing the 2 points that they picked up on the teams ahead of them, but still 20 minutes to get through before we can definitively say whether that will be the case. Either way, let's take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard brought to you by Jerry's Sporting Goods here and see what else is going on around the North American Hockey League. In Michigan, it has gone final, where the Warriors were playing host to the Eagles. An interstate rivalry there has seen the Sioux Eagles come back from a 3-1 deficit entering the third to take a 5-4 win. The Wildcats are going to be hoping that they can replicate that feat here tonight, overturning a 2-goal deficit entering the third. Janesville is up 4-2 over the Johnstown Tomahawks. Janesville at home in this one, as they lead by the score of 4-2. into the second intermission there. Aberdeen has a 1-0 lead, a slim edge over the Wilderness on the road. Bit surprising there, as the Wilderness are so strong at home on the year, 16-3-0 in Colquitt. In Topeka, the Rio Grande Valley is trailing now as the Roadrunners have just taken the lead. It is 1-0 in the middle of the second period there. Then elsewhere in in Odessa, the Jackalopes have erased a 2-1 deficit and are now leading 3-2 in the latter stages of the second period there at the Ector County Coliseum. In Brookings, it is 4-2. The Bruins are now leading over the Blizzard there in the second period in that one. Keystone up 4-0 over the Springfield Junior Blues. They're in the third period there as the Ice Miners are looking for their 8th win in their last 9 games. Springfield, for their part, are tied with Johnstown for the last playoff spot in the North Division. Minnesota Magicians are in Minot taking on the Minotauros. They hold a 1-0 lead. The Minnesota Magicians are 3-19-0 since starting 11-6-0, but thanks to Kenai Rivers' ineptitude over the last 2-plus months, the Magicians somehow still occupy the 4th and final playoff spot in the Midwest Division. If the season ended today, it would see the Magicians travel to take on the Wilderness. Ooh, that would not be a fun one for the Magicians, that's for sure. Later on tonight, the aforementioned Kenai River Brown Bears, who are still winless since November the 28th, are hosting the Cooley Region Chill. That's at 7:30 Alaska time or 10:30 Central time, if you feel like tuning into that one or following along. That's the first of 3 games there on the Kenai River. And in Fairbanks, the Ice Dogs are hosting the Wenatchee Wild. That also getting underway at 9:30 or 7:30 Alaskan time, 10:30 Central time. That is the Jerry's Sporting Goods out-of-town scoreboard. We'll keep you posted on those throughout the third period. And that'll do it for us here on the intermission show. We'll step aside when we come back. We'll have the third period of action with the Wildcats needing to do something they've only done twice so far this year: overturn a third period deficit. Stick around on the other side of the break. We'll find out if they can do that. Wildcats hockey presented by Armored Roofing will roll on just after this. back here at the King Yeager Coliseum. The Wildcats are down by two, needing a comeback. They are only 2-7-0 and trailing after two periods of play. Can they come back for the third time this season? The previous two against the Fairbanks Ice Dogs at the Showcase. The other one coming against the Rio Grande Valley Killer Bees here at the KYC back in November. Can the Wildcats do it? We'll find out right now as the puck is down and we're underway in the third period. Brought to you by American Classified as we skate 5-on-5. Headman pass through the middle of the ice. Sherrison couldn't reach this one. He'll chop this one down. Has some help from the linesman to hold the zone here as along the far side a loose puck is scrummed for. Knight holds this one. The referees unable to get themselves ably out of the way as this one is served back in deep. First to it here is Cortez. Yeager in on the forecheck here. He's out there with Sherrison and Farmer. Farmer tries to walk towards the middle with it there. Yeager was waiting in front. Rather, Sherrison was waiting in front, and he wasn't able to get there. So no Falconer shifting with the Wildcat, shifting with Farmer right now. Heading down the ice here is Chitwood. Puts Cook under some pressure there. Down goes the linesman Anderson as everyone in the crowd gets a little chuckle out of that, and we move on. Sherrison flings it cross ice. Farmer steps onto this one as he fields it off the wall. Chips it in deep and goes in after it. Bouncing puck spilled, and Pickar covers up. He let that rebound skitter away from him momentarily, but Wildcats weren't able to pounce on the rebound. 19:06 remaining in the period. As the Wildcats are trailing 5-3, the Ice Rays, for their part, when they are leading after two, 13-0-1. Polio, Staub, and APAP out there as that unit is back together after some time apart in response to Yeager shifting in Falconer's stead. Either way, the Cats will hold his own off the draw as it's Townsend floated towards the net, punched down in the middle. Staub fanned on it here, holding it at the blue line, or trying to as Townsend, but he wasn't able to do so. Tagging up is APAP. Going in on the forecheck here is Tommy Beaulieu, is Austin Beaulieu, as APAP gets back to the blue line. My goodness, as this one is skittering through the neutral zone here, gaining the zone here is Wes Michaud, stepped around Townsend. Michaud, ridden off there by APAP. First to it here is Azanaro. He has some trouble with it here. Now he's tied up. Works it free. Tries to find a teammate here. Chopped down nicely by Beaulieu, who plays this one cross ice. Stepping onto it here is Staub with a step around Crenon. Here's Staub walking towards the middle there. Fed towards the front of the net there as he was shoved off it. And this one caroms out into the neutral zone. Litviak trying to rag at the blue line. Left it behind here as Kuzin left it behind as well. Litviak waits for his mates to get off the bench here. And a line change on for the Wildcats. Litviak now swooping through the neutral zone a second and a third time before playing it off the boards in deep. Pickard will leave this one here. Rimmed around the glass. Trying to hold the zone at the blue line but unable to was Jeff Baum. Litviak picks this one right back up. Loses out. That one cleared out of play by the Ice Rays as it goes into the bench. 15:53 remaining in the third period. The Wildcats are trailing 5-3 as the second period saw this game explode into life. Four goals for the Ice Rays, three for the Wildcats. And here's the really surprising part. The Wildcats are really not getting a whole lot of shots on net. Not even like they're throwing pucks on net that are getting blocked. They're just not getting pucks on net at all right now, and no block shots were going to be a point of emphasis for the Ice Rays after they only were able to block two. But tonight, they haven't really had to. The Wildcats, just 13 shots on goal. That is a third of what they average on the year. Team is averaging 36.5. Off the faceoff, this is below the goal line. Oakley trying to hook this one back towards the middle there. Sprawls down to the ice and gets back involved in the forecheck here as a skipping puck is collected by Shane Kuzmeski. Kuzmeski quickly along for Baum. Banks it off the wall up ahead for Oakley. Bouncing puck. Oakley couldn't sweep this one in deep. Litviak gloves down in the neutral zone and looks to sweep this one along. Litviak now still on it. Loses it in the skates of Subri and turning it over here and chipping this one in deep is Howe. Baum back to collect it here. Canceled out there as trying to work it free was Howe for the Ice Rays. Picked up here by the Wildcats. Baum bumps it back behind the net where it's taken by Shane Kuzmeski. Kuzmeski steps out from behind the cage of Shaw, who relieves Zebnik in the middle of the ice, or in the middle of the game. Kuzmeski. Quick shot here. Same turned aside by Pickar. Behind the net, Kuzmeski goes in awkwardly here as the rebound was spiked right off his chest. Trying to dig it loose below the goal line. That's Eric Jaeger involved along with Sherazin. As Farmer is the man out there, Kuzmeski comes to the bench and Cook will step on for him. Below the goal line, the Wildcats will lose this duel. Looking to motor forward now, it's Nathan Breyer. Breyer steps past one. Offside play here by Breyer as Liliev couldn't keep his skate on the blue line. And we will get a whistle. 16:39 remaining in the third period. The Wildcats down by a pair here. As the difference in the game right now is the penalty kills. Corpus Christi is 2-for-4 on the PK. The Wildcats are 0-for-2 on the penalty kill right now. Faceoff, unable to collect it, were the Wildcats. It's Apap stepping onto a bouncing puck in his own zone as it's worked from Cam Knight back to the near side for Cook. Here is Cook. He'll look to play this one cross ice, spiked up and out of play there. Look out in the stands. Everyone's okay. The cross ice pass was red all the way. And that's been something we've noticed tonight. 16:25 remaining in the third as the Cats trail by two. Corpus Christi is much quicker to read that cross ice pass, moving from left wing wall to right wing wall or vice versa, as the D-men are stepping up and getting sticks in the way to break up the sequence off the faceoff. Wildcats will go in on the forecheck here. Staub, he's hooked off it. He'll look to stash it towards the corner. Bolio will chop it down and give to Staub. Play to the middle of the blue line. Here is Knight. Shot wide. They score! Deflected in front, maybe by Apap. The Wildcats have pulled one back. 16:11 left to go in the third period. Knight faked the slapper, then fed it towards the net. Might have fluttered in on its own, might have bumped off the body of Apap. Either way, the Wildcats are within one. We'll see the replay here. It's Cam Knight playing it towards the net. Apap definitely gets a deflection. That's Apap's sixth of the year. The Wildcats back within one. As we'll see if the pattern continues on the weekend. Team pulls within one, and then a two-goal lead is restored. But either way, this is Reisinger leading it forward for Oakley. Nice move by Oakley. Fed towards the middle, tied up there on the far side was Alex Falconer. So Falconer shifting in place of Litviak right now. Actually, a whole jumble here as Reisinger is playing there. Here is Gioschvili gaining the zone. Nice job by Azzanaro to take him off it. Townsend has his pocket picked, but he'll fight through the check and work it up to Falconer. Falconer into the middle of the ice. Reisinger couldn't handle it off his skate. Banked off the boards in front of the Wildcats bench area as Azzanaro gives it along to his D partner in Townsend. Townsend at the red line, chips this one in deep, gloving this one down and starting it forward. Now are the Ice Rays. This is Kuzin through the middle of the ice. It's Michaud, dropped off to the left wing wall. Michaud down below the goal line now, looking to play towards the middle there. Nice back check by Farmer to disrupt things as Azzanaro leads this one up ahead. Stepping onto it here was Jaeger. Sherazin trying to split the D. He couldn't do so. Jaeger plays it towards the middle. Karam's up towards the high slot. Kuzmeski on his backhand. Walks to the right wing wall. Loading shot. Blocked in front. It's loose. Kuzmeski ties up and puts it off the outside of the cage. Puck towards the middle there. And it's swept away from danger. Kuzmeski at the top of the circle will jab it towards the net there. Might have had better options, but the Wildcats keep play moving. Kuzmeski loading, shot off a skate. Here is Farmer. We'll look to play it back up to the blue line. Now Farmer towards the middle. Played in front there from Jaeger, and it was saved. Jaeger again played towards the front of the net there, and it was chopped free, held in by Baum momentarily, but a nice play by Lomsnitz to start forward. Kuzmeski will punch this one away from him there. Bodies tangle and tumble down to the ice. Baum and Farmer and Kuzmeski trying to work this one free. Kuzmeski lunging for it there. It's behind the cage of Shaw as first to retrieve. Here is Jeff Baum. Baum, little delay there and worked it along as Jaeger will wait for reinforcements. He'll get to the red line. Plays this one wide of the cage. Hard off the bench here is Bolio. Trying to hold his own was Apap. Stashed away from here. Now it's a foot race. Jeska trying to get there ahead of Colin Staub. 14 minutes remaining in the third. Staub and Jestra tangle up there. Staub bumped down hard. Good legal check here, but the Wildcats take possession. It's Matt Cook, left behind here by Bolio. He can't re-corral. Staub comes along to help out. Staub gains his own. He's upended. No call-up coming on a blatant trip. Oh, man. Back to the neutral zone it goes. Cook hit from behind. That's a second penalty that the Ice Rays have gotten away with in the last few. Apap kicked it along for Bolio. Bolio protects along the far side, just below the half hash marks on the wall. This is Apap tying up there with his man along the far side. 13:20 remaining in the third. Cats have scored in this third to cut it to 5-4. Shot blocked in front there as this is Jesko trying to save face and clear the zone. Wildcats held it in, now forcing it back in as this is finally worked free as Bolio is still trying to kick it loose. Still they scrum for it. In the neutral zone, finally the Cats will walk it free as Cam Knight wheels back to his own zone. Knight under the forechecking pressure there of Kruger spins away and now looks to motor ahead. Knight splits the D, left it behind there. Subri will re-corral in his own zone. Bumped off the wall there, he was hoping for Oakley. Litviak couldn't step onto the loose puck. This one wrapped around the boards here. Shaw couldn't reach it first to it. Townsend wasn't able to get there first. Sent down low. Knight the first to it here for Wichita Falls as the Cats look to push the issue here as they trail by a goal. Headman pass. Reeled in here by Litviak. Didn't take the hit there and lost the puck as Breyer will wrap this one hard around the boards. Shaw slows this one up here for Azenara to race onto. Now it's picked up by Evan Oakley. And now Litviak, he tangles up there with Evan Oakley and Kelly will play this one in deep. Oh, swept it around the Canes there. Played towards the front by Breyer off the wall. Connor Kelly in front. Here's Liliev. His shot off a leg there and went wide. Pinballing around there. It's picked up by Subri. He'll play this one softly ahead, hoping for a teammate. Sherrison left it behind. Jaeger steps onto this one, and at the red line, this is Subri sending this one all the way in as the Cats get a change on here. Inside 12 minutes remaining in the third period. The Wildcats are trailing 5-4. As they have pulled one back on a goal from Tommy Apap, his sixth of the year, on a tip in front. Sherrison gains a zone here, loading shot, partially deflected and goes wide. First to it here, it's Farmer, bumped up to the wall. Kuzmeski, bomb, holds on a one-timer, shot through the slot there, easily intercepted here, as this is picked up by the Ice Rays. Trying to fight through the check of bomb was Gioshvili. Bomb couldn't work it along to a teammate. Gioshvili in all alone in front, off the bar, and the Wildcats live to fight another day. Sherrison bumps this one along. 11:15 remaining in the third. All that stemmed from the Wildcats' inability to play the puck all the way down into the corner. Kuzmeski rolled it along here, hoping for Austin Bolio. Bolio with some trouble there. Chitwood wasn't able to maintain possession, as this is Farmer in his own zone. Softly across the ice, where Baum will step onto this one. Can't pitchfork it towards the corner, as this is playing down low, and it's taken here by the Ice Rays by Jestro. His headman pass, Gioshvili, walled off there by Knight. Knight lets him go, lest he take an interference call in the last 10:45 of the third. This is Matt Cook now. Cook, hard cross ice, finds Apap, the goal scorer in this third period. Here's Apap, puts on the brakes, shakes past Cronon. Apap in the corner, up to the blue line. Knight shot, save, goes wide of the Canes there as it pinballed off the base of the net. 10:30 remaining in the third. Headman pass, onside play here, but Michaud couldn't fish the pass free from his skates as Cook will give this one along for Cam Knight. Not the cleanest of passes there. That forces Knight to curl back and collect. Knight gave this one along for Matt Cook. Cook with 10:10 remaining in the third. The Cats still trail 5-4. Cook wheeled it back for Cam Knight. Now it's Knight. His pass through the middle. Falconer has some trouble, but it kicked all the way up to Reisinger. Onside, no offside play. As Reisinger wasn't able to get the puck in over the line in time. So we'll enter a media timeout here at the K. Yeager Coliseum. The offensive catalyst for the Wildcats tonight thus far has been Kevin Sherrison. He's got a goal and two assists to his credit thus far. No one else with multiple points on the night for Wichita Falls, but for Sherrison, that is his 10th multi-point game of the year as he has gotten goal number 20 tonight and a pair of assists. If you're just joining us, you've missed a wild one. The Ice Rays took a 1-0 lead in the period, in the first period. We'll be back in just a second. Back to the play here as it'll be a neutral zone faceoff coming in the last 10 minutes of the third. 9:59 remaining. The Wildcats are trailing 5-4. The game exploded to life in the second. 4 goals for the Ice Rays, 3 for the Wildcats. The Cats have gotten 1 here in this third period. That's where we stand. Oakley looks to play towards the middle there. Reisinger couldn't drive through the defense of Cortez to get that one onto his stick. Howe will chip this one past Townsend and hustle in after it. First to it here is Azenaro. Azenaro to Reisinger, now along for Falconer. Nice pass. Did Oakley to motor forward. Here is Oakley with a head full of steam. Oakley at the wall. Shot towards the middle. Falconer sent it wide of the cage. Pickard might have gotten a piece there. Pitched high up into the air. Floated back down the ice. Will this go for icing here? Shaw will ramp it along for Azenaro. We got a whistle. Oh, man. That's a botched call by Anderson. He blew the whistle way too quick, and now the Wildcats are going to have to deal with a defensive zone draw. Anderson, the linesman, lost sight of the situation. He blew the whistle as Shaw touched up. Not sure what he was thinking, but now the Wildcats have to defend a defensive zone draw rather than trying to transition back up the other way. Off the faceoff, one back to the point. Hard along for Carl. Carl plays this one around the boards. It was intercepted there by Sherrison and kicks into the neutral zone. Knocked down by a high stick here. Kelly will just let this one go as picking this up in his own zone with Sherrison. Flubbed it there, but got a pass up ahead on a second attempt to Jaeger. Jaeger fights through the check there and goes in after it. Jaeger looking to touch towards the middle. Farmer below the goal line now, and it works its way along for Liliev. Liliev in the last 9 of the third period. Cats still trailing by a goal. Fed along to the near side on a dump in from the Ice Rays. Cook will sweep this one away from Connor Kelly. Cook under some more pressure here. He'll spin away. Now look to turn up the ice. Got it along for Jaeger now. Jaeger looks to get to the red line. Fed softly towards the middle here. Caromed off a couple of sticks. And Sherrison will go to the corner to try and dig it free. Jaeger looks to shake it up to the point. Caromed along Kuzmeski towards the net off a mess of bodies. And caromed away into the wall. Swept hard around the boards. Bomb kicks it in to hold the zone. He held it in on a second attempt. Now on a third attempt, the Ice Rays finally clear the zone. Here is Bommel on the far side. Tries to jab it free. It worked its way loose for Apap. He'll send this one wide of the cage as the Cats will start up a change. This one glassed all the way down the ice. Having to hustle back is Austin Bolio. It will not go for icing here as Bolio swept it up off the far side wall. Held in by Kuzin. He tries to go towards the net there. It was intercepted by Staub. Staub and Bolio and Apap trying to work the puck free. It squirts loose as Kuzmeski will look to gallop along. 3-on-3, he'll skate. Here's Kuzmeski. Left it along for Bolio. Bolio stashes towards the corner on his backhand. Kuzmeski for Staub. Hard around the boards. Apap couldn't hold it in at the left wing wall as hustling back across is Townsend to pick this one up. Quickly up the ice, it's Bolio. He couldn't handle it cleanly. Giosvili chipped it only as far as the body of Bolio, who banked this one along. Nobody home there as a pitchfork effort goes wide to the cage of Shaw. He'll chop that one down and give it up ahead for Townsend, who got it along for Staub. Staub floats it wide and into the left wing corner it goes. Reisinger takes his man off it. Falconer now below the goal line. Ridden off there, Westmead Schott will come out to pick up the puck. A more stringent referee might have called an interference there, but that one's clean enough as Lomznitz brings this one forward. Loses it. Here is Kuzin now. Up to Carl. Whole lot of space. Carl loading shot and a glove save by Shaw. 7:09 remaining in the third, and the Wildcats trailing 5-4 as Austin Shaw comes up with a big save there to keep it a one-goal game. Faceoff will be to Austin's left. He relieved David Zevnik in the middle of the third period, or in the middle of the second period, I should say, as it's starting to get late at the KYC here. Good pace to this game. Good crowd here on hand as well. Ben Horner with you on FastHockey.com and the Wildcats Broadcast Network. As this in crowd of about 1,500 or 1,600, maybe a little bit closer to 2,000, has been treated to a good one here tonight, but the Wildcats are trying to send the home fans home happy. Last game of the 8-game homestand. They've gotten 5-2 on the first 7, as this is Kuzin unable to corral a hard dump in. No icing here. They say he got to stick to it, as Cam Knight will take this one behind the cage of Shaw. Knight slowly now motors this one up ahead. Farmer couldn't corral that one off his back skate. It's sent in deep, and Karam's off the back wall to be picked up here by Cam Knight. Knight off to the near side wall. Sherrison left it there for Cook. Softly ahead. Sherrison left it behind. Lomznitz spins this one into the offensive zone of the Ice Rays. Cam Knight will leave it there. He left it behind. Westmead shot on the turnover here. Poked towards the middle. Shaw will cover up after the Wildcats couldn't start the breakout cleanly. 6:16 remaining in the third. Wildcats are trailing 5-4 here from the King Yeager Coliseum. Reminder, the Cats go on the road next weekend. They'll take on the Lone Star Brahmas in what's sure to be two tightly contested, physical, hard-fought games. Off to the right of Shaw. Falconer to take the draw here. Falconer hooks this one back and will play this one behind the cage for Sherazin to start forward. Sherazin now. Drop pass. It was Reisinger. Now Reisinger plays this one up the ice. Will this go for icing here? Yes, it will. 6:04 remaining in the third as the Wildcats continue to trail 5-4. Face-off will be to Shaw's left after the icing against the Wildcats. Picked up by Wichita Falls, looking to motor forward. It's Falconer, his pass, hit Townsend in stride on the lunge. Townsend towards the net, spiked away there by Picar, who's given a good account of himself tonight. Held in by Azenaro, he was able to force it towards the corner there. Jester the first to it, but Oakley will tie him up. Oakley comes away with the puck. Here's Oakley, stashes down towards the corner there and goes in pursuit, swept along to the near side. This is picked up here by Azenaro towards the net, deflected and goes wide of the cage as Oakley had a stick in front of the net there. This one cleared off the high glass and down as Townsend will chase it back. Back in his own zone now, taking the pass from Townsend, plays it through the middle of the ice here, swept back along. Staub will hold the zone at the near side half wall towards the net, blocked down in front, puck is loose and Picard will cover as he had it in his breadbasket, 5:15 remaining in the third. As the Wildcats still hunting for that game-tying goal. They continue to trail. As the difference in this game right now is Matt Colford's goal at 19:23 of the second after the Wildcats iced the puck fairly needlessly and invited that offensive zone pressure on him. Back to collect in his own zone off the clearance by the Ice Rays is Cam Knight. Along for Matt Cook. Cook in some tight quarters, reverses it back along for Knight. Knight left it behind. He'll sweep this one in deep. Just over the red line he goes, as this is held in here on the near side briefly by the Wildcats. On a second attempt, they hold it once more. Boyo hooked it for Apap in the corner. Apap fed towards the middle, tied up there with Staub. Knight towards the net, save there. They'll scrum for it. It's under a body, and this is picked up by Colin Staub. It's Apap now, below the goal line. Works it along for Boyo. Banked up to the point. Here is Knight. Swept it along for Matt Cook. Cook settles into the middle of the ice, caroming around there, and it's swept away. Oh, and the net is off its moorings as Cam Knight was getting ready to wind up on a big old one-timer from just above the right circle, and that draws a whistle as the net was dislodged. 4:27 remaining in the third. The Wildcats trailing 5-4. They're out shooting the Ice Rays 5-1. They make that 7-1 in this third period, but only have the one goal to show for their efforts thus far. They continue to trail by one. Face off one here and brought forward now by Gio Shvili. Chipped towards the cage of Shaw. He'll sweep this one away from the forechecking Gio Shvili as Townsend does well to fight him off. Steps free, but he's tied up and hauled down to the ice. Joe Chitwood getting involved. He lost out as Sherazin plays this one cross ice. He was hoping for Jaeger, who was in front of him, and played towards the Wildcats' net in the form of Shaw. Rather, this was Townsend taking it for Wichita Falls. Sherazin almost stepped onto a loose puck in the neutral zone there. Would have been in clean, but Chitwood takes this one right back and gave it to Jestro. Jestro plays this one all the way down the ice. Should go for icing and will go for icing as Azenaro is first back to collect it. Will be to the right, rather to the left of Picard, Litviak, Subri, Oakley, Knight, and Matt Cook are out there for Wichita Falls. It's gotten late here fairly quickly. 3:51 remaining in the third. Held in here by Knight. Towards the net goes high and over the bar. This is Matt Cook. Towards the net. Blocked down in front. Follow-up chance towards the front of the net. Intercepted there. Someone is without a stick as this is brought slowly forward by Lomsness. Lomsness takes a good hard bump there around the shoulders from Evan Oakley as the Wildcats look to start up the ice in the last 3:30. This is Cam Knight in his own zone, slowly wheeling it forward, dropped it for Matt Cook as the release valve, hooked along here by Subri, onside play, Offside by Schacht. Eesh. A debatable on that one. Either way, neutral zone faceoff coming. 3:21 remaining in the third. Wildcats continue to trail by the score of 5-4. They'll have a neutral zone faceoff upcoming here. Off controlled here by the Ice Rays. They've been good in the dot in this third period. Settled here as it skipped towards the cage of Shaw by Townsend. His pass misfired for Bolio, but it will come up short of icing as we hit the last 3 minutes in the third period. Cleared off the glass, caroming into some space in the neutral zone as Matt Cook will play this one back for Townsend. Townsend looks to start it forward. It's Colin Staub. Banked it in, but not in deep. He'll hold his own, however. On a second attempt, Apap does as well. Here's Apap. Forced down low at the half wall. Bolio gets involved there as well. Here is Bolio. Can't walk towards the middle. Now it's Staub. Banks it up the wall for Cam Knight. Knight looks to walk down the left wing wall now. Needs some support. Knight plays it below the goal line where Apap will have to hustle after it here. First to it was Lomsnes. Tied up here as now Staub will try to dig it free in the last 2:30 of the contest. Cats desperately hunting for a tying goal. Bolio has it on his blade. Can't work it for Staub. Puck loose in front of the net there, and it was taken away, but the Wildcats will have to go back and chase as this one is cleared down the ice. The icing here against the Ice Rays, though, so with 2:16 remaining in the third, the Wildcats will have an offensive zone draw coming, and you think we would see a timeout taken here by the Corpus Christi Ice Rays and John Bukanik, the head coach. Now we will get the timeout taken, and it will be taken by, I believe, Corpus Christi here. So that'll let them change up. It will be taken by the Ice Rays. 2:16 remaining in the third. That will allow the Wildcats to draw something up here as Coach LaFontaine gathers his charges. Wildcats are trailing 5-4. Tommy Apap pulled one back from Austin Bolio and Cam Knight at 3:49 to the third. Since then, the Wildcats have piled on the pressure, but Corpus Christi has sat back and absorbed everything thus far. And with 2:16 remaining in the third, we'll keep an eye on when LaFontaine and Saransky will make the move to pull Austin Shaw in the cage to our right in favor of the extra attacker. Even if the Wildcats can pick up just a point, just a point in tonight's contest would be huge. Every point crucial as we get down to the stretch run. Farmer to take the draw. Shaw still occupying the cage to our right for now. Offensive zone faceoff is coming to the right of Picard for the Wildcats. Ball start off the draw. Sherazin, Farmer, Jaeger, Cook, and Cam Knight out there for the Wildcats. Shaw taking the draw here for Corpus Christi. Off the draw, one back, tears Matt Cook. Looks to shake it down below the goal line. Farmer is getting held there, finally released by Michaud, and Krasichuk, the referee, missed it. Cam Knight quickly along for Cook as the Cats will tag up. Cook rims this one around the boards. Off to the far side it goes. Jaeger kicks at this one here. Here is Sherazin, shot, save, rebound covered by Picard as Farmer takes a little jab up high from Michaud after the fact. 1:56 remaining in the third period. The Cats searching for a fifth goal to tie this one up. Shaw is still in the cage to our right for now. Picard is in the cage to the left. He has stepped in for Lindgren tonight and played fairly well. The Wildcats hoping to beat him one more time. Apap to take the draw here. Bouncing puck. Quick shot. Save there. Fought off. Rebound. And it's sent wide of the cage. They'll jam for it down low. That was Staub with the chance. Up to the blue line. Azenaro swept along here for Townsend, who holds. Shot towards the net. Punch down in front. Rebound is still loose. They'll jam for it. It's a scrum. And it's picked up here by the Ice Rays and cleared down. Only as far as Townsend in the neutral zone. Off a few bodies. Bolio at the red line in front of the Cats bench will send it back for Azenaro. Townsend mishandled there as Lomsnes will send this one wide of the cage of Shaw in the last 1:25. Azenaro Left it there as Bolio will pick it up and look to motor forward. Here is Austin Bolio now. Bolio walks through to the right wing side. It's Staub. Staub shot. Save there. Rebound is loose. Shaw still in the cage as this is sent down the ice. Will it go for icing? No, it comes up short. 70 seconds remaining in the third. Wildcats trailing 5-4. Townsend, as we tick down towards the last minute of the play, brought to you by La Quinta Inns and Suites. His pass for Azenaro. Too far. Azenaro will shovel this one along. Pitch high up into the air. Glove down at his own blue line by Townsend. Shifted along for Sherrison to race onto. Sherrison gains the zone. Has it spiked away from him. Here comes Shaw to the bench for the extra attacker. Empty net in the last 45 seconds of the third. Trying to dig it loose with Sherrison. He lost out to Joe Chitwood, though. Chitwood will float this high up into the air. Staub settles in his own zone. Still time for the Wildcats, but they must hurry. 35 seconds remaining. Cook, fresh from the bench here. He'll look to play this one up ahead. Now slows things down. Steps inside a man and will chip this one forward and hustle in after it. Cook towards the net, wide of the cage to Sherrison. Far side half wall. Sherrison left down below the goal line there. This is Colford intercepting and sending it the length of the ice. 15 seconds. This will come up short of icing. The Wildcats have to move this one quick. 10 seconds remaining. Knight being too slow in his own zone along to the near side. Farmer jabs forward. Can't find the handle. Fed along for Staub. 3 seconds remaining. Staub can't get a shot away. And there goes the horn. Ice Rays take this one 5-4. The Wildcats launched a pretty solid comeback attempt. But at the end of the day, an 0-for-2 mark on the penalty kill is going to spell their doom, as well as a late second period goal to Matt Colford. We'll step aside and break it all down on the other side of the break, as we'll conclude Wildcats Hockey presented by Armored Roofing just after this. Back at the K. Yeager Coliseum, putting the wrap on an exciting game by the Wildcats. A good, strong performance as they tried desperately to fight back. But at the end of the day, much the same way that the Ice Rays couldn't overcome an early two power play goals allowance for the Cats last night, the Wildcats could not overcome an 0-for-2 effort on the Gilmore's Collision Center penalty kill, despite the best efforts, as the Ice Rays are able to pick up just their second road win of the year. Let's break it all down. We'll get you the scoring summary here. Anthony Cortez scored on a big blast from inside the blue line on the power play in the first period. That was all for the scoring in the first at 7:40 of the opening frame. The game sprung to life in the second period, though, as Tanner Lomsnes scored just a minute 25 into the second as the Ice Rays capitalized on a carryover power play after Evan Oakley took an offensive zone tripping minor at the end of the first period on a bit of a soft call, if I'm going to editorialize just a little bit. The Wildcats charged back after that, though. Kevin Sherrison got things going with his team leading 20th of the year at 2:23 of the second, as that would be just the start for Mr. Sherrison. Then Max Reisinger picked up a power play goal for the Wildcats just 3 minutes later to make it 2-2, as Sherrison and Subaru picked up the assist as Reisinger swept it home from an acute angle and it nestled into the base of the net of Luke Pickard. But the tie game was short-lived. The Wildcats gave it back as Anthony Cortez scored another big blast, and that was enough to chase David Zevnik, or rather the next goal was enough to chase David Zevnik as Nathan Breyer got one past him, as that was all she wrote for Mr. Zevnik. Nick Farmer pulled one back on another power play tally for the Wildcats. The Wildcats' power play went 2-for-4 on the night. Strong effort on the weekend. They go 5-for-10. Not too many games that you're going to, or not too many weekends that you're going to go 50% on the power play and not win both. But when your penalty kill only goes 2-for-6 on the PK, 33%, it's real hard to win hockey games. More work to do there on the penalty kill for the Wildcats. The Wildcats looked like they were sitting okay there heading into the third period, but at the late stages of that middle frame, it was iced needlessly by the Wildcats as it was just thrown carelessly up ahead by a man in the defensive zone. It was either Lazarus or Oakley. I'm not quite sure who it was. Either way, on the ensuing offensive zone draw for the Ice Rays, there was a mad net mouse scramble after Huser put it on net. A couple of guys dug for it, and after the Wildcats had swept away a couple of chances similar to that earlier in the period, they were not able to replicate the feat as Matt Colford stuck it home past Austin Shaw for the eventual game-winning goal. In the third, Tommy Apap pulled one back on a deflected shot in front. It was Austin Bolio and Cam Knight getting assists on the goal as Tommy Apap picked up his sixth of the year after tipping one home from Knight's wrist shot from the blue line. But despite the Wildcats' best effort and despite outshooting the Ice Rays 10-1 in the final 20 minutes of this contest, they were not able to pick up that game-tying goal to get themselves to be able to force overtime. With the loss this evening will be Austin Shaw as he gave up the game-winning goal. He played well and called upon as he made a couple of big saves on that big glove hand. And unfortunately for the Wildcats, David Zevnik was not at his best tonight. And at the end of the day, that's going to burn him. Hard luck loser is Austin Shaw as he gave up the game-winning goal. It's the only one he allowed as Zevnik gave up four goals on 13 shots. Shaw gave up one goal on five shots, making four saves. With the loss, the netminder from Highlands Ranch, Colorado, falls to 16-6-0. With the loss, the Wildcats are now 27-11-0. They are 24-10-0 in the division, 16-5-0 here at the K. Yeager Coliseum. With the loss, or with the win, I should say, the Ice Rays improved to 20-13-5. They are now just 2-11-5 away from home, but they've won two of their last three road games, if you want to spin it that way, and they are 19-12-4 in the South Division. Let's take one final look at the out-of-town scoreboard here to see how this all might play out for the Wildcats at the end of the night. They know they don't lose any ground on Lone Star, but that was a game in hand, and the Wildcats could have jumped back into second place had they won this one here this evening. At the end of the day, not able to do so. Let's take a look at what else is going on around the South Division on the North American Hockey League. Jerry Sporting goes out-of-town scoreboard. Odessa up 5-3 over Amarillo as the Jackalopes looking for their first win over the Bulls this year. In Topeka, they're in the third period, and the runners have opened up a 3-0 lead on Rio Grande Valley. And I don't want to get ahead of myself, but I am fairly confident in saying that one is likely a foregone conclusion at this point with about 10 minutes remaining in the third period there. Reminder, the Wildcats are off until next Friday and Saturday when they'll hit the road once more after this 8-game homestand. That saw the Wildcats go 5-3. They'll take on the Lone Star Brahmas in North Richland Hills at 7:30 both nights on Friday the 30th and Saturday the 31st of January. All of the pregame for you at 7:15 on FastHockey.com and the Wildcats Broadcast Network. Until then, I'm Ben Horner saying from all of us at the Wildcats, you've been listening to Wildcats Hockey presented by Armored Roofing. Have a good night, everybody, and take care.